Okay, I'm having a good fuse to talk about the Kardashians today. You are on your own, Amy. I can't do it. I've had enough Kardashians. I can't take any more Kardashian stories on this show.
Okay, well, we got to get into now because you mentioned it, John. Kylie Jenner got a new... So Kylie Jenner got a
new... Let me ask you this, John.
He left.
Let me ask you this, John, because it'll kind of flow into the story and you don't have to talk about the Kardashians. How would you like it if your daughter named her pet John? How would you like that? That's exactly what Kylie Jenner did. She got a little gray, beautiful, fluffy rabbit and named it Bruce.
Oh,
I don't care. This family, I'm sick of this family.
But do you think
I can't take it anymore?
Is there something psychological behind this?
It's like a non-story. Like it's a non-story. We're talking about this family.
This poor gentleman.
Every freaking day on this show. Nobody cares about this family anymore. I've had enough. It's Friday. I want to have a good Friday. I don't want to talk about the Kardashians. That's enough of these guys.
The sad part about it is that I agree with you.
Does anybody listen to the research? Nobody cares about the Kardashians anymore.
That's not true.
He's on fire.
Nobody cares.
We
do it every day.
Breathe. Breathe, my love. Breathe. There. The news is out. Done. Over. Have a great weekend.
I think it's Friday.
Why do you give me these videos, Kaz? I'm as mad as this guy that I've got a Kardashian video to open my fucking show with.
Watching like hours of newscasters losing their shit, and that's an old one, but goddamn, he went full on like he was ready to quit. He was in the background like signing his resignation. Like I don't care. I don't fucking care. John, I need you to stamp this. I want to get out of here by 6. God damn it. Like, I'm going to fucking 2 News. I'm going to do the goddamn weather. Goddamn fuck this entertainment show.
So I've seen this happen before in other videos and whatever. It's you're very as an anchor person or even as a radio anchor person, a lot of your news and stuff and your production team do the thing and then they send you the copy. More Choco, please. way to start a show. I fucking always forget to turn that off during the podcast. Okay.
Let it go. Let it the whole thing.
They do move in herds. Choco the dog, everybody. Choco the dog. So your copy gets delivered to you and then you're reading and you're like, oh yeah, and the traffic's this and blah blah blah, and I fucking don't want to read this next story, and it kinda hits you like without you knowing about it. There was one lady I think that was
because
she tried to set her like fucking copy on fire so they couldn't have her read it, and they were like, no, we're contractually obligated to fucking read that story, and they're like, no, I quit. I'm done. Which I understand. Every time Kaz brings up another fucking weird Asian robot story, I'm like, no, not today. I want to have one good Sunday week where we don't have to talk about, you know, right?
Jerk right. Bots.
No, what? No, no, cooking what? Bots, no. Cooking bots.
Oh, that's me.
Dan is actually a Japanese robot that's been programmed. We've never seen him from any other angle. He's actually got wires hanging out of him.
Yeah, all these turns are just, it's kind of a glamour. You can't actually see when I do a full turn. Mm-hmm. Smart. It's what the apron's for.
Choco's the one running the show, actually.
Well, yeah, nice. I'm actually just a little man.
why am I still talking? Anyways, one of the things I wanted to say today is this is DKG Welp episode freaking.
We still have an intro the goddamn show.
We keep forgetting. And on top of that, and what's beautiful about what I've been loving about having guests like Dan and Bryce on is that one, the show is completely just a hang out with your friends, chill out and talk about crap show. And Kaz mentioned this. He's like, I want to get Dan and Bryce on because I'm going to even like kick down the news stories because for the most part, we're just going to talk. And if you look, not the people that are watching this recording, but we went to the pre-show and we just talked for like a half hour, like before even starting it. Yeah. And that's just bonus for you people that come out to the live shows, which you should do more often if you're listening to this on iTunes later.
Mm-hmm. If you aren't listening to this on iTunes and you have no idea what you're listening to, you're listening to dkgWELP, the Drunk Kids Gaming Podcast. Hello, I'm King Kaz. I'm the host. That's Curley. That's Bryce. And Dan has walked off screen and now he's back.
Episode 30.
Episode 30.
The age that I is.
The age that I is as well.
Before we go into the news story, I want to preface that I do have games today. Two of them. Well, one of them is another Limerick thing, and then one of them is an actual game. So if you guys want to prepare yourself.
Do I have to write? Oh, God damn it.
The Limerick you don't have to worry about. The Limerick you just listen to, and if you answer it, you answer it.
Okay.
They're not long. They're, you know, rhyme, one long sentence with a rhyme in it, and then the rhyme that matches the top two.
Well, these are the ones that Kaz is going to get every time.
He went Rain Man last time. It was insane.
I want to thank Tupac and Biggie.
He's got to be good at something.
Yeah, right. He found his calling.
And all of the Korean rap music that I've listened to over the past 2 years. All of it.
So if you guys want to prepare before you go to the show, and I'll just tease the game that actually has the involved paper. You need three cards or paper that you're going to hold up to the camera to submit your answer. One of them you're going to write Yiddish on.
Oh, wait, the word Yiddish.
Yeah. Not something
I don't know how to write Yiddish.
Well, no. Hold on. I had one friend who was...
I know I got the curl, but...
Your second card, you will write the word Klingon. And the third one, you will write Bob Marley.
Oh, no.
Dan, I promise you there will be no child abuse in this episode, as per our agreement.
You better not. Every damn time.
But anyways, yeah, you don't have to worry about that. Kaz has news stories.
I do have news stories, and if you want to play me a little tune, I'll...
Let's fill that knowledge hole. It's Kaz's news bag.
I'd like to thank our friend Friendzone Radio for making that for us.
Friendzone Radio! Big Voice Jay. I don't know who did it.
Yep. So, as always, whenever you do a show on the internet and you read stories, you're going to read a number of stories from Florida, and we are not any brighter.
Every episode so far.
No, there's a few. We did a lot of Texas stories a couple weeks ago, but I digress. A Florida woman was arrested for flashing breast and throwing meat at her neighbors.
Are those phrases the same thing?
Nope.
Throwing hands.
Flashing breasts and is also known as throwing meat.
Yeah. I think that's a male equivalent.
Explain.
These are things I need to bring up on the podcast because they cover our week. So somewhere along the lines, I brought up the term throwing hands.
Isn't real.
Yes, is a very East Coast term for
we're gonna throw hands. Right. Hold my earrings, we're gonna throw hands.
Gabby was convinced you were saying throwing hams.
that does work in Smithfield.
A bad Christmas party.
But all the West Coast kids had never heard this, like Curley, Sunbun, all of our friends. So they automatically lost their shit, and they're like, "What the fuck is throwing hands?" I'm like, "It's a fight term." Like,
no, it's not.
It is.
No, it's not. Don't back him up, Bryce.
What is it then?
Throwing hands.
Yeah, come on.
I'm thinking we're
gonna throw. Hands.
My mind immediately goes to Mega Man, and he has a gun that shoots a hand out.
You nerd.
Immediately what I think about.
No, it does not.
I'm not throwing my hand. How do you, like, you throw something by holding it in your hand? You don't then chuck a hand. Like, how do you
throw punches.
No, instead we take our trifold pamphlet guns and shoot them at each other. That makes more sense.
Wait, hold on.
Cinder says, I've heard throw down. I've heard throw down. Let's throw down.
Well, sure. Throw down. Yeah, throw down, throw punches.
Yeah.
Throw hands.
Throw punches is the equivalent of throw hands.
But those are two different words that make
you're gonna catch
meanings.
Tell me you understand catch these hands.
Catch these hands?
I have not heard that phrase in my life.
You got it. You're gonna catch these hands if you don't fucking throw hands.
No. You guys, East Coast has an obsession with hands, apparently.
They love hands.
You're going to catch these hands if you don't throw hands.
At the
hands.
Very least, context clues.
I think Bryce is doing a whole bit right now to make Cass feel better. I think he's running a long fucking con right now.
Water fountain versus bubbler? Who the hell says bubbler?
That's not a word. That is not an East Coast thing. No.
My East Coast relatives, there's no...
Someone's making up words again.
All right. But to this story, so this woman
throw hands is like a ballet move where you just like,
no, it absolutely is not.
Yeah.
So this woman got intoxicated in a trailer park and proceeded to try to fight all of her neighbors and then flashed one of her neighbors, her breast, and then proceeded to knock over a barbecue and pick up the meat and throw it at people.
Okay, well, seems like a valid progression of situations.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's about as I'd escalate it that way. Yeah.
I mean, I feel like I've seen this fight in my youth. This seems like something I've actually witnessed as a child. And the
barbecue would burn your hands. To me, I would get a chair. Is nobody else caught? It's hung up on the picking up meat and throwing it.
Well, when you want to throw hands,
oh, I love that this website doesn't try to pretend that it gets an actual article writing news journalism. There's no quotes here. This 31-year-old she-demon was charged with disorderly conduct. That's just what they wrote. I feel like you're not supposed to take an opinion of the article you're writing about.
Well, you know what that means? If they didn't get a quote, they just heard it or got it off the police blog.
But the way it's written, though, and if you read this from the Times, you'd actually be like, was it actually a she-demon? Like, was that a real thing?
Yeah. She, like, straight up had horns and, like, popped through a portal from Beelzebub's realm. Yeah.
And she was throwing disfigured hands at everybody. It's crazy. Yeah,
throwing disfigured hands.
I also love the she was accused of toppling a barbecue grill and tossing pork chops on the lawn.
That sounds right. I mean, it doesn't sound too bad for, I mean, the hellmouth that Florida is, I think this is actually kind of like a light news day.
But I also now that you said what you said, Curley, I'm looking at some of these sentences in here, like, but the owner of the pork chops understandably retreated rather than stand and face this act of aggression.
Hold on, she got pork chops.
He didn't defend his pork chops?
Stand your ground.
Flower up. A white trash backyard brawl, right? Like, at some point in the newsroom, they're like, you can't just write that she fucking threw shit at the guy. You got to make it, she's got to be a demon, it's got to be a war, and it needs to have absolutely no direct quote.
So I actually know what happened here, because it seems weird, the situation where she went from being super aggressive, yelling at people and everything, to then flashing titties.
Flashing.
And then right back to aggression and throwing the ham and toppling the barbecue. But so I kind of feel like I know what kind of happened, because this happens to me all the time.
A titty demon?
No. She was angry, and she was definitely ready to start fighting, but she accidentally hit her taunt button, like in TF2, right in the middle of the fight, and was just like, no, stop. Oh, damn. All right, well, I'm still alive. I can throw ham now.
Yeah,
happens to me all the time in TF2. I
took it more along the lines like she got so drunk that she thought she was like a big, like, burly dude, so she like lifted her shirt up like, you want to fucking go, you want to fucking go, but everybody else took it as like, oh my god, that woman there is flashing her.
She's trying to get me titillated. It's only kind of working.
She's got her headlights out.
And you have a next story?
Yeah, I do. All right. So this is something we've been talking about throughout the week as this has gotten crazier and crazier and progressed more and more, and even after the fact it has continued to progress. So the Powerball,
this is my Kardashian moment, fucking Kaz and his Powerball stories, man. I'm like, so I don't want to talk about it. He's like, but what would you do if you won?
No, this isn't a what would you do if you won. So this young lady or this family has set up a GoFundMe to recuperate the funds they lost in spending all of their money on lottery tickets. And they would like your help
America
to get money back.
Okay, wait.
I actually read the story. Lady spent a bunch of money on the Powerball and then opened a GoFundMe to recuperate cash because now they can't pay their rent.
More or less than $50,000.
I think the shit only had like $100 to her name.
No. Because I mean, it's dumb.
Autoplay video, please. No.
There goes your internet.
Because
love you.
If you were like, I spent $100,000 on lottery tickets, then I'm like, okay, you fucked up on a big scale. Maybe somebody in your family just needs a website to toss you a little dough, right? Just keep it above board.
Mm-hmm.
But like, if we're talking $1,000, $2,000, like, dog,
that would put me under, bro.
No, yeah, definitely. But I would also laugh in your fucking face if you were like, can you give me my money back, please? I lost.
I mean, it's a big old joke, right? Like, they're pretending it's not a joke. Like,
is it?
Well, I mean, she says, I mean, in the GoFundMe article, which is now deleted, by the way, you know, we've exhausted all our family's funds on lottery tickets, expecting to win, and are now in dire need of cash. I'm certain that we'll be able to pick ourselves up from the trenches of this loss and spend another fortune trying to hit it big again. Like, they're just joking. Like, I think, you know, like, well, I mean, much akin to Mr. Fucking, you know, send me $100,000 and I'll cook the soup on, you know, Kickstarter or whatever that was. The guy that
did people ever get their
potato salad guy?
Yeah, no, he became a big sensation.
Yeah,
I don't think he offered to send stuff to people. At least originally, he was just, I'll make potato salad.
He ended it with stretch goals that were like, I'll make your specific potato salad if you're this into it or we get this far with it.
He was going to send people some of it. Like, I feel like
he was going to have a party for the big guys.
I think that's what it was. It's like big spenders would, he'd make it for them.
And so, like, I mean, I don't, in all honesty, like, as much as the story is fun to like make the joke about it, but like, this is kind of a smart idea if it took off and didn't go the other direction. Like, the potato salad thing is dumb as hell, but that guy got an internet sensation and his cool 15 minutes of fame out of it. Like,
and money.
Yeah, and money. Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Not just the 15 minutes of fame.
You miss 100% of the shots you don't take, right? But at some point, it's like, that's just day class A. You've just attached your name, your Google name, basically, to something kind of stupid and not even like, I don't know. Potato salad is like a harmless thing, right? If you saw it, I'd be like, okay, you were trying to make a joke, right? But this is just like dumb.
But it's, I mean, it's like people who try to.
So I can't actually. I don't know how to say this correctly. So I'm gonna just post it in the chat and let you guys use your own mind's eye. But my favorite is the response that they got from Michelle. I don't know what it was. Someone posted on the
GoFundMe.
The GoFundMe this response, which I think is glorious as one sentence. So if you can read that in your own mind's eye.
I am integrating Sweater God.
It's so good, right?
Sweater God.
Sweater God.
As a fucking episode title.
Sweater God. It's good. It's
you
a good response.
You have to use the A's and the W. You have to use A-W-D.
Oh, yeah. I'm copying it straight as it is.
Oh, Pet Vet.
But God.
I love it.
God.
I mean,
so is that it? Is that it?
That's the whole thing.
Okay.
That's the whole episode. We're done.
Because with lottery stuff, with lottery, when there are big lottery prizes, the news stories that you get are, somebody won, or somebody did something kind of stupid, but it's a very small thing anyway, and it's only related because we care about $1 billion, right? Like the story of I think there was like a video of a girl who thought she had the right numbers, and she definitely did not. Just like little stuff like that is pretty inconsequential and in the grand scheme of things kind of tangentially related. This, I agree with Curley, this is like a Kardashian story for me.
Boom. Two against Kaz. Delete him. New co-host needed.
The leader of the dream team, the team that I'm on here in Twitch. his dad was on CNN because he had the winning tickets from the previous week.
Oh, that hurts.
And he didn't realize it.
Yeah, see, I don't
until after, and so he was like, "Holy hell, I won!" And and then yeah, CNN pulled him on because his story was basically he thought he won, he reported it, and then they were like, "Oh, you? No, you didn't."
I don't let myself ever accept a thing that's like lucky like that unless there's like 18 times someone has to tell me like, "No, it's real. Oh, it's real." Yeah. I would just be like, "Nah, man, that's fucking fake." You know, like whatever. I don't let that happen because I would probably explode.
Yeah, it was kind of funny and also sad.
Oh, terrifying. Yeah. Anyways, Pet Vet's here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and.
Hey, I'm Pet Vet, and you're listening to Drunk Kids Gaming.
Oh, Pet,
that's so nice.
It's so adorable.
Anyway,
carry on, Cass.
Let's get through this. All right, so we had a Pornhub one last time when Fallout came out, and Pornhub was like, "Yo, Fallout's killing our traffic." But apparently, Pornhub likes making graphs and shit and letting you know that they track things. So according to Pornhub and their data collection, the search term Minecraft in their database is becoming more and more of a thing between January of 2014 and December of 2015. More and more people are going on Pornhub and searching the term Minecraft.
So,
here you go.
Millennials can't even do porn right.
Or... So you take it as one of two things, right? You take it as either they can't do porn right, or they're so locked into like the things that they grew up on that they're now like, "Hey, I wonder if pretty sure maybe, you know, let me."
There's too many to get to the top of these lists. That's too many to expect, because I'm gonna have to look at some point now.
So I pulled it up. I'm surprised. Oh my god, so many fucking ad redirects. So a lot of this, okay, well, some of these are like legitimate just let's plays, like the top
on Pornhub.
Yeah, the top six are let's plays.
One is how Pornhub the new Twitch TV?
Is it a let's play with like a cam girl?
No, these are like,
I mean, that would be like the only thing I could think of in that situation. No,
this guy's wearing a shirt. There's no picture on this one. This one's just a TV. Someone just filmed their TV like a scrub.
What? You know where I should upload this, guys?
Porn. You see the view numbers on porn? Like, it's ridiculous.
They're for...
Yeah, but do they get out the ad revenue, or does Pornhub?
I don't know, make a
probably
deal.
Probably Pornhub, right? I don't know.
I would
there's
say
one. There's one that I can tell is like, what is this? Like,
I'm not clicking through, by the way.
Actual machinima? I'm going to do it on...
This machine's running. Yeah, it's running the damn stream right now.
Oh.
So, it's... Oh, God. Oh, God. It's like, it's really robotic because, oh, my God, her head turned all the way around. So like the oh my god, it's a guy is doing the voice and so yeah.
So okay, there's production values. You got production values.
No, someone is at the scene. So there's a woman.
A Minecraft character.
A Minecraft woman, the blocky kind of thing, and she's got blonde hair and it goes down to her back, and it seems that she's not wearing any other clothes, right? It's just skin tone.
Sure.
Okay. So the guy goes, "Here I come." And her head turns 180 degrees. Her body does not move. And he goes, "Oh shit." Okay.
Thank you for this is Masterpiece Theater with Bryce for the audio only listeners.
Spread them legs. And her body, okay, her body does like the Vitruvian man, right? Like legs akimbo, arms out. Her head is still facing completely backwards, by the way.
Sure, why not?
And her, yeah. Okay.
What are you watching, Sarah Lane?
So the naked Minecraft guy comes in. He goes, "Go around." And so her body turns around, but her head is still backwards. All right?
Okay.
What is this, like The Exorcist Minecraft Porn Edition?
There's got to be some benefits, because, I mean, the block angles don't scream to me sexual. Like, they don't...
And then there's just this really robotic, like, humping motion of just, like, his body kind of doing this. Like, just, like, pivoting, but, like, not even animated well.
Are there genitalia?
There's no genitalia.
It's Minecraft, of course not.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So there's been a cut. This whole video is only 45 seconds, and there's three distinct segments. This one is them doing 69, which seems to be the most ineffective sexual position to show via Minecraft. Because it's just
you can't tell what's a head and what's a butt.
No, but you can, but the heads are just like rotating. They're just pivoting, and there's obviously no detail or anything. And you hear him just go,
oh, no, so it's not two actors. It's one guy doing the voice for everything?
It's one guy.
Oh,
doing.
Good. No, good. Yeah. That's what I need.
He probably produced it and paid for it.
The end title is Minecraft Porno 4. Thanks for watching.
Number four. Okay.
The first three were very successful.
We are in the wrong business, all of us, guys. I don't understand. We have the ability to make it big.
I wanted my face on things, I guess. I'm sorry.
I don't know what the hell I'm doing cooking.
Stuck with that Minecraft thing, huh?
The beautiful thing is I could explain all of this right now if I was the guy doing that to my dad, and he still would not have any idea what I did, and he would probably be just as proud as what he is right now what I'm doing on the internet. He's like, oh, so there's that game. I heard of Minecraft. I heard they made a lot of money. Is that what you're doing? I don't know.
When Pornhub announced this, they also released, like, their other top searches, and they're all like video games, right?
Sure.
Right. Yeah.
And all, like, 90% of the first page of results on Pornhub was Let's Plays for Minecraft.
So either the millennials
Let's Plays on Pornhub? Is that what happened?
I think that's what's happening. I'm not joking. Like, I know these kids, these millennial kids. I know my coworkers' kids that are in their, you know, 13s and 14s, and they are weirdly addicted to things they really like. Weirdly addicted. Like, I was in to Pokemon as a kid, and I was into Digimon, but I still could separate and go and, you know, masturbate for a while. Okay, like, and not be like, oh, fucking Digimon nudes, come on. Like, I didn't go there ever. Not even as a question, like, if it was possible. And I mean, I get it, but I don't get it with kids these days, because they're like that, man. They need it for everything. Everything has to be some kind of connection to it. It's weird.
But it's not even porn. That's the thing. Yeah. It's like en masse. This is not even, it's literally.
No, what it is
there even pornography.
Okay, so not going too deep into porn, because I promised Dan we wouldn't make this whole episode like this.
Shit, I'm sorry.
But what do you do when you sit down for, you know, a porn session? You think of, like, okay, what do I want to look at today? What do I want to look at today? And what these kids do is they sit down and they go, okay, I'm going to look at boobies or whatever it is. But then they go, God, Minecraft is really fun. I could be playing Minecraft. Oh, man, but I'm really kind of, I'm in the mood to do the thing.
No,
let's just look at Minecraft. Let's type Minecraft into Pornhub. And then they're like, oh, crap, sure. Let's Plays. I can just watch more Let's Plays. Oh, I forgot to masturbate.
I'm not going to disagree that Let's Plays are good jack-off background. Jack-round material.
Jack-round, yeah.
Yeah.
Even
just logistically, Pornhub is not a good place for that. Pornhub doesn't have apps. I couldn't pull up Pornhub on my TV.
It's like HTML5. It runs better on phones than Twitch or anyone else does.
But not like YouTube. Like, I don't know. It's bizarre and it's fascinating. I would like to talk to anybody who's done this and understand why they chose Pornhub.
To go off the side of, like, the actual porn and the actual Minecraft stuff, what Pornhub does with their stat collecting and their aggregation of it, and then what their API that they let you look into, you know, stats from counties and from states in regards to what they're searching for, when they're searching, what months and everything in years, and the trends, all that data collection they're doing from a nerd standpoint, completely unrelated to porn, I freaking love every bit of it.
No, what was it? Was it cancer research, or there was some charity that refused Pornhub's donation. There was something.
Really? Yeah, Pornhub's, the guys that are running it are pretty freaking genuinely interesting nerds, right?
Yeah. Well, like, I can't remember what it was now that they were trying to sponsor, and they told them no. So they donated, like, all of the revenue from, like, a week or something from the site to some other competing charity. It's like, well, screw you. Like, I think it was the biggest, like, breast cancer research place. Well, so, or not the big one. Like Susan Conan or whatever that one is.
Coleman, yeah.
So I think they refused it, and they went, well, screw you. We're going to send it to the other one then. Like, we were just trying to raise money for, you know, breast cancer because we hate cancer. Like, it was...
I saw that they were doing, like, their own in-house content, and not necessarily porn, but they had... And very specifically, and this is what happens to me, is I get distracted easily. So I was at the website, and I was intent on doing things, and... I found that they had a video of their that they had produced themselves, you know, Pornhub, you know, exclusive, or Pornhub, what would Netflix call it? A Netflix original?
Original.
Pornhub original. And it was, they had brought on a bunch of the stars from different things that you'd, you know and love from your average pornos. And yeah. They had very much like a BuzzFeed video quality. Had them all watching
top 10 money shots.
No, they had them all in different groups watching the ticker that they have, which is literally just a live feed of what people are typing into Pornhub search. And
porn stars react to Pornhub
to the ticker, and they're like, "What the hell is that?" Like, "Oh, this." And then like this one girl was watching it with this other one, and like they watched the ticker go by, and her name popped up, and she's like, "Oh my god, it's me!" And he's like, "Yay!" Like, and it's like it was adorable and cool, and totally like distracted me from ever going and finishing anything. But it was great content. I mean, go Pornhub.
Yeah, I mean, that was the thing I found interesting. It's just like the amount of data collection that they do, and like
I love it.
Shit that they get out of it, which also to me at some point just makes me come to the realization that like either their branding is so good that people are just like, they think like, oh man, oh, I'm going to go to Pornhub, like over the just generic Google search for X thing, you know?
Well, and also, well, I don't know. It's weird. 'Cause like Pornhub is like a big conglomerate now, right? They own like all the big sites, right?
Sure.
That's my understanding, is that they Bilderberg grouped it all into one thing, and now they are all
aggregator, bro. I have no idea where this stuff comes from.
I guess original content is what you do when your business model just makes money hand over fisting.
Damn it. You pun.
Fuck you.
All right. This is the last one from me. And then Curley has a game.
Hand over throwing fists.
Shit. This is the one Curly walks away from. So
it's a Powerball Japanese robot jerk off child abuse.
If you got $700 lying around, you can buy a life sized anime figurine.
Life size. So
why?
Life size.
Kaz, why?
Oh.
Kaz, why?
Same reason as body pillows.
Why?
Huh?
Why?
Because you got $1,700 lying around?
For half of that, fucking for a 17th of that, you could you could get a girl to hang out with you that's life size as well.
You could even, like, you know, maybe try to ask someone out to lunch and pay for it and hang out.
I was just saying.
The problem with that is it, they don't look like your waifu when they talk back. I mean, I'm just saying, like, there's some giving some tick here. You
the
know,
internet
like,
gods are trying to shut you down, yeah. Kaz, because this is just crazy.
Absolutely crazy.
As Pet Vet said, it's anime and it's life size.
But it I would be totally down for that sort of thing if it was like. Like, do a, you know, like a Sword Art Online sort of deal. Like, I'd be totally fine with, like, lifestyle anime that I could interact with in, like, a world. But that's why I don't get figurines that aren't...
articulated?
Well, I'll grab one, for instance.
I like the term wife-size waifu. That's great.
Wife size, you know, something like this. Like, I like these little things.
Oh, like it's a bobblehead. It's
yeah,
like
a bobblehead or a Funko Pop or whatever, because
oh
they're silly.
Goodness gracious!
And it's just
welcome to the channel, Zine Combine.
You know, that's the sort of thing I like. But with anime, like, it's a show I watch while I put it, when I do an anime. I watch a lot. I watch a decent amount of anime
on Crunchyroll.com.
Yeah, I do.
You can get a 20% discount for Crunchyroll.com/DrunkKidsGaming.
Good to know. I didn't know.
It's
that.
Not real.
I would probably instead just go through, you know, Lane or something. But anyway.
Sorry. Yeah. Damn it, Lane.
I know.
Works.
No, I'm thinking about it now. And I mean, maybe because I just went, because you said life size anime girl, right? No, you just
it's
anime.
A character.
Well, so this, the, from this anime. Website was immediately like, here's this life size schoolgirl. And I'm like, that sounds dumb to me. But I'm thinking about it now. And I'm like, dude, I would like a fucking badass full size, you know, Piccolo just like in a stance in the corner. That'd be cool as shit.
But
not for $17,000.
Yeah, you got to really fucking be into Piccolo.
$17,000, you better be able to live in it. You better be able to drive in it, or you better be able to fuck it.
Like I
it
have
to be a body like costume that you can get in and out of.
It better teach you how to be a Namek for $17,000.
Well, and it needs, like, I mean, with all those things, though, like, are they posable? Like, can you remove clothes? Like, all those sorts of things. Like, are you able to, like, change their outfit? These are the questions that I'd want to know with this, because if it's just, like, one of the figurines that you put on your desk, and that's, or, like, your shelf, and it's there, and it's all in one piece, like,
you can
I know
tell
some
that
of them are customizable, Kaz. Like, I know that
this,
some of them are.
This doesn't move
like
at
that.
All. This is crafted as one unit, and it's beautifully painted.
Yeah, and see, that's silly to me. Like, you might as well get a cardboard cutout at that point.
It's
like,
shipping on that?
I can look. Well, you're not going to care about shipping if you've got 17 grand to drop on it.
Well, so here's the thing.
Try to get that on Amazon Prime.
Do you have the free one-day shipping for that? It's over, like, $50.
So they're only making 10 of these, and you have to apply to get
dude,
into
holy
the
crap.
Lottery.
This guy's, like, carving them. Like, these are statues almost.
Okay, well, okay, that's a little different. And if they're like carved art, that sort of thing, okay, I can see that a little more.
I'm sorry, I went nasty on this. I thought you guys were fucking dolls. I'm sorry. that's what I immediately thought.
You could still fuck this doll. Let's call this beta thing. You could fuck this doll.
Welcome, Life Bean. I'm so happy you hit that follow button. You're an awesome.
But okay, so that's okay. That changes my opinion almost right away. If it's like a full size carved, you can put like kind of an art factor to it. Like, like someone made this for me. Like,
it's a one of a kind or
masterfully created one of a kind. I can get more on board with that.
Money's at?
If it was just we 3D printed this sucker, you know, of. kill 100 times again.
Oh my goodness!
Like,
Dr. Buckles.
That would be the sort of thing that's.
I want
no.
like a life size freaking Cloud Strife from Final Fantasy VII with a big old Buster Sword. Just
hold on, right? Because now I have this to throw into the fray. One of these, Dan, shaped as you, in your Neko Maid dress.
I would buy a Dan, one of a kind. If
you'd
it was
you dropped 17 grand.
Not 17 grand. I mean, everyone's got their price.
Oh my goodness!
But if Dan came, you know, if Jamie came out and was like, "Hi, my next project is, you know, I'm going to carve Dan out of this chunk of marble."
You saw the I don't know if I can find it really easily. You saw the fan art of me as the Neko Maid, right? Did you see that?
I didn't see your fan art. No, I saw your Twitter.
You didn't see the fan art because it was beautiful. I'm gonna see if I can find it and I'll show it to you guys.
No, it'd be cool. Like I have a lot of extra room in this house. I would love like a whole wall of my favorite casters as full on figurines. Or get what are those old
size.
What are those old things that they had for football people? The big old giant like wall poster sticker things like.
Oh!
They used to be on Cartoon Network all the time, and they'd be like, "Get your fucking Blukaduke and put it on your wall. It's like Terrell Johnson's right there in your house catching a football." Cast you smell toast. Cast you smell toast.
Smile for me. Smile, Cass.
That's it.
Oh, Lord.
That's true. TJ's correct. Why are you trying to permit me? I'm a damn mod.
I'm trying to permit you.
No.
To rest of the day, I can edit the channel whatever he wants.
Yeah. Oh, someone posted her Tumblr. Okay. Well, then I'm... Where am I? I know I'm on that, then.
I'm on the right kittens. Track. I'm going to sniff this down.
I'm gonna find one that...
I don't know how to use Tumblr. It's...
Well, it's just...
I'm not going to lie. I always start out on like a nice Tumblr and like an arts Tumblr or like a photography Tumblr. And then somehow I end up three links down and I'm in a like how to fucking shit your balls Tumblr. And I'm just like...
How to shit your balls.
What did I click? Like, I started on an art Tumblr. Like, why am I here?
You guys are welcome.
Whoa!
Oh my god.
This is what kids are Googling these days. Oh, it's like dripping on you and shit, bro.
So that was done by Electro Kitten.
One grill is wearing the bottom piece of a bikini, and the other one is wearing the top.
Yeah, I love that I'm surrounded by grills.
Yeah.
Hot
grills.
Hot, that is exactly what they are. Yeah, you're welcome, Krantz.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, so that's what happens when fans, and that's what happens when you're in the creative section, and you know the good artists in the creative section, is they do stuff like this.
We're just gonna go ahead and put this on the desktop, save that for later.
And so, like, this is the type of pose you would expect for like a real life,
and that'd be beautiful.
The problem with that, and I'm looking at this one that the news story is about, and I'm realizing that the life-size anime figure, actually has two positions, and it's you can look. I'm not going to get into conspiracy, but the arms are in front.
Stop.
The legs are straight. I'm just saying.
Okay. All right. So Kaz is out of stories.
Thank you, Kaz.
Thank you for bringing those into our attention. So in your opinion, that is the most important things that happened this week in the news.
Wow. No, this is the fucking most like gross, weird, what the fuck things that happened in the news.
Okay, so my limerick thing is again, I've with full disclosure, I've stolen this from NPR. So they do this as an introduction to three different news stories that they talk about the week, and they're not the most amazing internet stories, but whatever, who gives a shit?
Wait, I gotta write shit down.
No, these are limericks.
I know, but I guess it
we'll do the other thing later. Do you remember your three things for the other game?
No.
Yiddish, Klingon, and
Yiddish.
And Bob Marley.
Marmalade?
Bob Marley.
Marmalade.
You can put a marmalade.
I heard marmalade.
In my opinion, same thing. No woman, no jelly.
Limericks.
Limericks. All right, so this one's going to be... and we're going to have... I guess we're going to have a winner, I guess. Yeah, we're going to have a winner. So the other game is going to work just to accumulate points. You don't have to worry about timing. But this game is going to be whoever answers first. So, buzz in with your answer.
Shit.
God damn it. My nose is so fucking stuffed in the wrong way. I can't blow it. Okay. Chipotle love. Nothing can calm it. The health code is there, but they bomb it. You'd think salmonella would stop this hungry fella. I still go, though it might make me
vomit.
He's a Rain Man. He's a Rain Man of limericks.
Oh.
He's that...
I don't entirely know what we're doing right
so
now.
So you answer the last line of the limerick. Sorry.
Thank you. Now I know the rules.
I guess I should have said that. Sorry. Fuck. We did this at the top of the show last time.
Like...
This is like... It's like I'm really playing the DKG show.
I actually wrote an intro to this. I'm going to read you three news-related limericks with the last word or phrase missing from each... I need you to answer the last phrase.
Oh.
I wrote that on this document.
And yeah.
And I skipped over it.
And yeah.
No, I skipped that. I have my own. I keep them away from you guys because they spoil. So yeah, that leads into the story. Apparently, Chipotle is not having a good time. Just this week specifically, they announced this thing where marmalade will work. So actually, Chipotle announced that in February 8th, they're going to close all of their store, all their 2,000 stores.
For like two hours?
For a day, so that they can hold...
No, it's not a whole day.
Well, they're going to hold an all-staff food and safety health issue meeting.
Well, that's right. They're closing their stores down for like half a day, countrywide or something.
Like some kind of insanity.
Yeah.
And it's understandable because they keep...
12 hours!
I want to say it's the WHO came out and said...
I have the details. Go ahead.
The outbreak is settled and Chipotle is E. coli and Chipotle are they're divorced and it's not a big thing.
They
and
sent E. coli packing.
They divorced amicably.
But yeah, I guess 100 people fell ill in California after they had to close, 43 stores because of E. coli.
Right.
In 6 restaurants. And then in December, they had 100 students in Boston College after eating Chipotle because they had some sick person working there, and it was the what's it called, virus or something, norovirus.
Norovirus, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And they were just like, I don't know, throw the meat on his face and then roll it into the food. It's going to be fine. That's how we do it here.
Just throw the hams.
Yeah, they were throwing hands for sure.
I guess, like, the day that the WHO said that the outbreak, whatever, was, like, settled, there was another case of it from Chipotle, of E. coli.
Right afterwards, yeah.
Right after.
They were like, yeah, we got it. No. Are you mixing that up? Or is that an actual story you read?
No, that's really a real thing.
Well, because on NPR, I actually read a separate story that was as soon as the CDC declared
CDC.
Well, as soon as they declared Ebola cured, the day after.
You know what? I'm thinking of the Ebola thing.
Okay, it's different rules. Yeah, because I was like, wow, that sounds exactly like what happened with Ebola.
It's a lot. I'm thinking of Ebola.
Yeah, that's a shitstorm. They were like, all right, we did it. Fucking mission accomplished. Ebola's gone and taken care of. And it was one day later. They're like, we got an outbreak over there. And they were like, fuck! I swear to you, who let her out? Who let her? Tim, were you on the doors? God damn it.
Yeah. I feel bad for fucking Chipotle. Like, the few times I've been there, I've enjoyed...
Chipotle did not have Ebola. I'm sorry. DKG did not report that Chipotle had Ebola.
I'm sorry. I did not check my sources.
Breaking news. Kim Kardashian has Ebola.
Oh, no.
That's good news.
That's good news.
All right, what's your next?
Well, no, there was some guy that said I lost the quote because I killed the document earlier, but there was some guy that was quoted saying something along the lines of in the Times article that was like the whole idea about Chipotle can't be quit no matter what they fucking do. Like, the guy was like, I heard about the disease and everything, like, but you know, Chipotle is like love, and sometimes in love you got to put up with some bad times. And you're like, what are you talking about? Like, god damn it, stop eating the burritos from the place that gives everyone fucking E. coli.
Okay, but here's the thing. There's a Qdoba right down the street from me, or a Chipotle right down the street from me, and there's no line.
I'm not joking.
And they're on sale.
So when you're like, did you wash your hands?
So
yeah, I do check. I make it like, hey, are those new gloves? Can I get new gloves?
A couple years back, I was living in North Park in San Diego, with Erica, and there was a point where we had gone to every Mexican food restaurant within 10 miles, and we knew the one that we liked, that was the one that did everything right for both of us, and everything was great. And we went there once, and we were sitting outside, and we looked on the window, and it had a which I had never seen before. You see the food rating.
Oh, the health inspector.
And it was just proudly displaying a B. And
okay, it's not like
I've never seen not A. Okay, so
I've seen B.
And I just had to like, I'm like, dude.
Some of the best Chinese places in Seattle, I've definitely seen those Bs up on the wall.
Yeah.
We scored a B.
Worse than a B.
Yeah. I'm like, I'll take that shumai. I don't care. That's B worthy right there.
I had to question myself. I'm like, am I above this?
Am I? You just know, right?
You go, but this sauce though, man, this fucking sauce, they get it right. The sauce got an A. The floors might have got a B, but the sauce.
They get it. They got, I mean, they, the right size. They put the right stuff in it. They never fuck it up. They give you extra tortillas. Everything's good. But man.
Well, you know what? They're doing it in spite of the B. They know they've got a B. They're going to be better than the B.
Well, like the B is like you've got 30 days to fix the issue. You're going to wear this B for a while as your scarlet letter. And then you'll get your A or you'll go somewhere else. Like, and so it was a reason thing. And I'm like, oh man, what fucking health inspector found a roach in the beans? Like, God damn it. Like,
the B, like, at least in my mind, like I see B and I'm just like, I got B's in high school. Okay.
I don't know if it's the same way.
It's great. I was happy to get a B.
Like, I got a B. I got a B in calculus. I will take that B. That's awesome. You know, and like, you move on. And you know, you don't go, ooh man, I'm going to need to change something. Nah. It's fine.
All right.
You just realize you didn't write that extra paragraph for your theme, and you got a B.
Yeah. Like, you know, one paragraph. I didn't go the extra mile, but I did pretty well.
If Dan gets big enough, enough of you sub to him, he's going to have health inspectors in his kitchen because he's making food.
No, it's funny. Drink. Like, I'm going to have to. You're not wrong.
Yeah.
You're actually not really? Wrong.
Oh, I know. My ex tried to go through the. She was trying to like make cup pies for the internet and stuff. And it's like California's like, oh, you have to make it all in a federally inspected kitchen, and we're like, no, our kitchen's not federally inspected.
So that's a little different with baked. If I stuck to baked goods and hard candies, this is a really big tangent. I actually would not have to get a inspected kitchen, but I would go online for like a baked goods out of home non seating permit. There's something. It's like there's a specific permit that fits me.
All the people that I knew in the, because my ex went to an actual like she went to a it was a small, it wasn't like a college, but it was a small independent
culinary school.
And and they were all like, what they all did is they actually just all rented 2 hours of time from the school to use the kitchens that were inspected.
That's pretty common.
They actually didn't bake there. They just baked it at home, but they just had it on the paperwork that they were like going to the college to do it.
Yeah.
And they made all their stuff for their bake sales and their time that they bought at fairs and stuff and sold it from there because California's crazy.
So at least with Seattle,
what was their name and social security number? Again?
Yeah, right. Yeah. Sorry to put it all on blast. I said X, right? X doesn't matter.
Yeah, you did. Well, at least with Washington, bake sales for charity or like fundraisery things like that, you don't need anything.
Oh, California, they're like, was this made? I need fucking calorie count. I need ingredients.
California.
You know,
that's freaking California.
It's Rice Krispie treats. What's in it?
Rice Krispie treat and you're not from California, they instantly claim, well, you made income here, so therefore you need to pay us your income tax. Thank you, California.
Don't get me started.
Move to Seattle, Curley.
It's not any better. I mean,
yeah, it is.
What he's calling a hot dog in a fucking in a roll that doesn't look like bread on the street and cops it.
That shit does happen and I understand that, but you can't spoil the fucking free market for that. God damn it. Anywho's next limerick. Thank you, Chipotle. I still love your black beans and rice. It's delicious. All right, here comes the limerick. Prepare your faces so Kaz does. I'm going to put Kaz in a fucking timeout if I have to.
I won't answer this one. I'll let it go.
Though Amazon helps the consumer, they grow like an uncontrolled bloomer.
I already know it.
Though it wasn't malignant, I got quite indignant. FedEx delivered a...
tumor.
Yeah.
Duma. Yes. Kaz has found his fucking calling. I'm scared.
Well, there aren't a lot of words that rhyme with
sure.
Consumer.
I know these aren't that great, but you're not supposed to fucking just get it.
Isn't that the point of the content? Isn't that the point of the game to get it?
Yeah, I mean, right at the fucking first line, it's scaring me.
It's not a tumor.
So this leads into the news story, which I'm surprised Kaz didn't have. A British man, James Potten, got a package from FedEx. He had ordered himself a brand new Christmas Kindle, and what got delivered was a box that had instructions on it that read specimen return kit and had a patient's tumor enclosed in it.
Nice. Putting that on a wall. You ain't getting that back.
Yeah. He was very British about it. I got a quote. I haven't opened the sealed box. It says patient exempt tissue, and it doesn't belong to me, so I didn't open it. If FedEx knows where my Kindle is, I'd like to have it at some point. But yeah, man got delivered a tumor.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to say this because I had a brief fundamental misunderstanding of the news story for a second. I thought Amazon sent him a tumor. Like, Amazon put it in the package
and their witchcraft
and sent it. Not that there was a I guess the tracking numbers got fucked up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The tracking numbers were pretty close, and then for whatever reason, it delivered a specimen of medical stuff, which probably has a strong time restraint in regards to when it needs to be biopsied or whatever, and it went to Mr. James Potten.
Yeah. No, Dan, please.
I was gonna say, I feel like did Amazon give him anything for that, or was there any suit, or just, by the way, you sent me a tumor, kind of a health hazard, can you compensate me for that? Or did it just be like, oh, sorry, can you put that, can you print out this return label and just send it on its way?
Yeah,
like, drop this off at UPS.
They actually made him pay the return shipping.
First of all, he got it the next day, so it was good. Calm the fuck down.
As of the time that I read the story, I'm surprised at the news article because they said it was later in the day that the FedEx guy had turned his truck around and came back and got it after he reported it, and they had pictures of him giving it to the FedEx guy. I don't think they had the follow up yet. Welcome to the channel, Cherry Lunar. Because I love you.
So this article that I have says it was like 2 days.
Oh yeah, so yeah, it was like Sunday. It was like later in that weekend.
Oh yeah, no, I come back on a Sunday, babe. Like, you lucky, like,
still no words on my Kindle, please. Did it go to the hospital?
So funny thing. I actually had it wasn't a tumor. So that's my.
Oh good, no.
Thanks. Okay. Good to know.
Yeah, yes. It was not a tumor.
Tragedy lever.
It was not a tumor. But I was sent the wrong package. And I was like, this happens occasionally. Okay, yeah. You get sent the wrong package. The problem was they just swapped the orders. Like, if you looked at my order history, it showed the right thing. And then if you looked at the box, it was a mess to try to get returned. Because they looked at it and went, no, we shipped you the right stuff looking at my order history.
Gotcha.
And they practiced. They argued. It took me about an hour. I got like this Lego head filled with Legos, and I ordered Cards Against Humanity. Some like 3 year old.
I mean, on some level, I understand the mistake.
Yeah, basically, I mean, some 3 year old got a pack of cards, one of which is, what is it, like Pac-Man ferociously guzzling cum?
Yeah.
Some child
got
that
in Lego. You should have just made that in Lego.
I should have made it in Lego.
Well, you should have hit Twitter up like James did, because that's my favorite part of this that I forgot to look at.
See, I didn't think about that. Well, I did, but I wasn't where I... This was like... Frick. I mean, it was before I, quote, made it big. So, like, my Twitter was like, you know, at 80 people or something at the time.
He hashtagged it with FedEx fail and hashtag not my Kindle.
So,
tonight's game is brought to you by...
Welcome, do you want the...
It's a ball.
Your name leaves me in suspense.
Right. Oh my god! I went to the first link that James made with the photo of the tumor kit, and like half of these replies are from news reporters asking for interviews. This is disgusting.
Well, yeah, you want the stories, man. That's a fucking story. We could have got the interview, but Kaz is slow on this. The update.
Sleeping. Kaz is sleeping.
Next limerick.
Follow the whole British Empire for you. Fuck.
When I'm a fishing, the lines drive me crazy. All the waiting and beers make me feel hazy. No more fish will I lose when I snooze on this cruise, because my app helps me be extra
lazy.
Yeah, that's an easy one. Very easy one.
Yeah, I figured that out from the first line, too.
No, well, apparently this is the last episode of Limericks we ever do, because our fucking panelists are asses. But yeah, no, this is a new app / hardware that you can buy, or I think is being kickstarted right now, actually, called Fish Sentry. And it's the hook and the bobber link up to the phone via Bluetooth and report movement when you get a bite. And it tells your phone that you should now start to reel in or pull or whatever the hell you have to do.
Wow. So that is fishing is already lazy. What the hell? Hold on. You see,
Now you don't have to feel the pole at all. You can just walk away and drink those
championships on goddamn ESPN, Dan.
Yeah, you know what? That's because the only way that that's legit is when you're catching marlins, because those things are monsters. If you're like, I got a trout. It was a big trout. Good for you. You sat in the water with a string. Like,
so
I went fishing once in the San Juan Islands. It was amazing. I sat in a boat and tanned. That's what I did. That was my fishing. I caught a rockfish doing that. Did absolutely nothing.
Was it a rock?
Rockfish delicious though. Rockfish.
It is. It wasn't in season. I had to throw it back. But but it was.
This app could have told you.
No, the thing that gets me right, like
a fish. It's just been like, look, you got a fish. Yeah, I can feel that due to the fact that I'm holding a damn pole.
But what if your hands are going and being used while to chug the 12 pack of Budweiser you bought? Those
you
tall boys.
Be fishing.
Both hands.
Why the hell are you fishing? Go a river float.
You got to have one hand opening the can while the other one is used to chug the other one, and then you alternate.
It's called river floating, and you sit on a tube, and it's lazier, and you don't have to deal with fish.
Oh, you guys are mad about this.
Dan is really mad about this.
Not okay with this.
I'm not even like it works over Bluetooth, right?
Sure.
So there's got to be some sort of a delay with Bluetooth stuff.
No,
right?
No, are you kidding me? No.
Sometimes.
Not Bluetooth low, like 4.0. I use it to start my car. It's instantaneous.
It just seems like, oh, like if I'm in the mode where I'm not looking or holding onto the rod, then I'm not even paying any attention to it. So I have to have my phone.
Yeah. You're over there doing bro fists and chugging, or doing that thing where you pop the top and the bottom of the can and then chug the beer.
Shotgun. The shotgunning is what it's called.
Okay, I don't know these things.
And I may be able to do that faster than anyone I know.
I've never been able to not cover myself in beer.
It's
I have bad throat reflexes,
you
apparently.
You can take this however you want, but I can very easily open my throat and chug beer.
Of course.
And challenge
and
accepted.
Like to see that one.
I really, oh yeah, I did that on the river float that I was just describing.
People who were in frats were
shocked that this nerd could chug a beer faster than them.
There's a picture somewhere on the internet. I think it was on my MySpace, and I might have it somewhere. I don't know, but it's just a solid state. It's a straight picture of the exact moment right after I realized I wasn't going to be able to swallow anymore from the beer bong that someone tried to give me. And so I'm holding a tube shooting beer out, and I look like someone has killed a cat, and I'm red, and I'm just like, no, and I'm like, I'm panicked, and there's just, it's everything is scary in the world of my face.
Am I accurate?
And you can tell that everyone behind the camera is probably laughing horribly, and I'm in the kitchen in a chair just with like the stop, and there's just, it's ready to shoot out, and I'm like, and I can't handle this anymore.
You have to, what you have to do is you have to kink the hose, and that'll stop the flow.
Well, I didn't.
See, it's just.
I didn't
spew
beer everywhere, but the photo looks great. Yeah. That being said, I still got all over myself, no matter what.
We'll take this back to the fishing thing, which is.
Sorry, I tangented that.
Yeah, no. It was a good tangent because it made me think of this. There was a point in my life where
it's a new title Dan Throat.
There was a point in my life where I loved old white man things. So like I was really into watching. I was really into NASCAR.
Okay.
So I will tell you
the list. No. Continue the list. Of old white men things you like.
New title, old white men
things. I'm going to need three things on this list before we can go on to the rest of your story.
Bryce has a whole list of old white men things he likes as well. He wants to get to.
Golf. I was really into golf for a while.
Yeah.
And it wasn't just because of Tiger Woods. Like, I was
man. I like that delegitimizes it.
No one. Yeah.
But no, like I would watch fucking Bash. It would come on ESPN, and I'd be like, "Oh fuck! Oh, Big Red's gonna get him the day, man."
I'm trying to imagine Kaz watching NASCAR.
Yeah, what's number three? I want to know what number three because I'm about to tell you something that. Okay, what was the three?
So bass fishing, NASCAR, 20-year-old white girls, and golf.
Okay, you have, well, not the 20-year-old thing, but you've
one
described
of those
my
things
father.
Is not like the other.
Wait, Dan, how old are you?
No. Are you my father-in-law?
No, but I don't know what it was, but it was just like for a while, I got in trance one time. And I will tell you, the thing that got me into NASCAR was one day I was just sitting there and I turned it on and I was like, man, this is fucking dumb. Then they started talking about the points and they were like, all right, well, if he passes him, he's going to get 10 more points. And then if he comes around that corner on 9, he's going to be in the lead for about 174 points. Now we got 160 more laps to go. Now, if Jimmy John could stay ahead of him.
I thought that was just whoever wins the race. I didn't think there was
right.
No, there's way more.
It's not a roller derby
system, man. No, Bryce. There's a whole point system. There's per pass.
Do we need to stream a NASCAR game now?
Oh my god! I will NASCAR voice the fuck out of a NASCAR stream.
I tried to date one fucking NASCAR girl. One. I took her two places during our dating scenario. One of them was the Santee Rodeo. And the other one was to a NASCAR fucking, not a NASCAR race, but a race at the speedway that was down here. And I was fucking bored out of my goddamn mind. And a tire came off and the fucking crowd lost their goddamn minds. A tire came off on a corner and the tire came out of the car and just kept going on the track. And the whole crowd was like, go, 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 go. And it kept going around the track. And it was like the greatest thing these people ever seen in their entire life.
NASCAR is by far the most boring sport to watch in person.
Fuck you, Bryce.
Bar none, it is the most boring sport to watch
in person. My father-in-law goes to Georgia every year to watch NASCAR.
Darrell Wartrip wasn't my guy. Jimmy Johnson was my guy.
That Mr. Beam bring or I can't. I'm thinking of
Mr. Bean.
I'm seeing an N or an R and an N. Mr. Byrne, Mr. Beam.
M Beam.
And on that note, actually, I meant to mention the gamer me has a good point. I didn't drink when I took this girl to this place, so I don't know. Maybe if I drank during a fucking NASCAR.
I mean, that is part of the thing. It's kind of the idea that you go, you drink. I mean, think baseball.
It's a social thing.
Baseball to me is incredibly boring, and I'll go with my family on occasion because they love it. And it's, I mean, I'm cheap, so I'm just like, oh, frick, a $10 cider. Like, why the hell would I want to do that? Because I don't drink beer. And so it's like, well, I want something to drink because it'll keep my mind off of people running in circles.
The sheer boredom.
Yeah, I mean, seriously. And I feel the same way about NASCAR. And it's funny, my wife does too, at least with NASCAR. She'll just be like, hey, so I'm still talking to her brother who's also into it. Like, hey, I see they're turning left. When are they gonna go the other way?
At least with baseball, you have things happening.
Yeah, no, I give it credit there. Like, to me, I see a lot more skill in baseball. I just think it's boring.
Sure,
but I can totally respect, and I know they can do way better than I could ever do at that sport. NASCAR, I know it's competitive, and yeah, they can drive better than me, but it's still boring.
I don't know. I agree with you in all aspects of all the things you just said.
I don't know. I agree.
No, I do. I have nothing to add to it. Like, I am the same way. Like, I am, for some whatever reason, fate-wise, in a family filled with baseball-loving aunts, grandmas, uncles, and I'm not really necessarily a black sheep because there's plenty of other family members that take the black sheep title quite easily because they're shitty. But everyone's just like, oh, come on, get Brian Jr. out to the old baseball game. We got they all have season tickets and they all have front row stuff and I've been pulled out there before and then I get guilt tripped because the amount of money that it costs to have me there and I'm like, I don't want to be here. Didn't want to be here when I was 12. Didn't want to be here when I was 9. Now I'm 30 and I still don't want to be here, but I'll be here. But yeah, screw sports. And fishes. Catch your own damn fish with grenades like a domestic Dan. That's what he does in Seattle.
No, I don't do fish most.
Yeah, I heard your wife's not into the fishies. That sucks.
The fishies. No, she has fishies. She's allergic to fish.
Fish issues. Yes.
God damn it.
That's glorious. This is an amazing episode right now.
That totally sucks.
They're amazing.
It is. It does suck. It does suck. Especially because we're in Seattle.
Yeah.
And there is amazing seafood here. And so there's like, it's rare. Sometimes I will break and I will just get like a tuna steak and I will eat it myself and be like, sorry, honey, you're like, getting mac and cheese. Awesome because she loves it.
Do you come home and she's like, it's nice to see you. And then you're like, I can't kiss you.
It's not that bad of an analogy.
Oh, okay. Otherwise, she'd be already I've broken the cardinal sin. I've had the tuna.
The way I view it is just Dan's like, I'm going to go get our food, like order food, but gets his like his fish sandwich and he's in the driveway like.
Well, I mean, my car tuna.
Yes.
Car tuna.
You got the handy wipes all ready to go.
Yeah. No, I mean, like, I made spicy tuna onigiri recently, and that was some real good-ish. But again, it's like...
Yeah, I mean, sushi and stuff, too, up in Seattle, right? Like,
oh, my gosh, it's so good. It's just...
Oh, that blows.
I'll go and get it. And thankfully, with sushi places, we can go there, and you can get, like, the vegetable stuff.
Sure.
And then I can eat more fish, because what she gets is, like, super cheap. So that works out. But dim sum we can't touch because of cross-contamination, because of the whole B rating on Chinese restaurants.
On the ratings of the restaurants she goes.
I'm not joking. She cannot eat there.
All right,
two pieces of rice, like sticky rice that they make. It's like, oh yeah, I'm starting to get a reaction because the rice somehow got shrimp in it.
All right, we're gonna just start calling our show 2 hours long because this is the way it's going to go every time at this point. You know...
But Dan made me think of one thing, right? One of the things. I love my mother to death, but she's like almost allergic to everything. So when we go out to eat, you have to then give them a list of shit that they can't touch other shit with,
right?
Or then that they sucks. Have an issue because somebody's gonna die in the dining room. So like you get there and you automatically like when you don't have an issue with food, you're like, oh man, fuck that thing on here. You see this thing? But then you're like, you look across from you and you're like, oh,
can't be on the same tray,
right? They can't even be in the same fucking zip code, can they?
Man, I'm just lucky as fuck. I have no one in my life with food allergies. I have no one near me. With food allergies. I've never had that experience. I get it. I understand it. I just, you know, the first time I ever got into it was when I had the kid that had the parents are weird about peanuts and everything. And
oh yeah.
You know,
I was out to dinner with someone.
I just laughed at my own shitty self
this year. with someone who had, a gluten allergy, right. And a legit gluten allergy, not like I don't eat gluten. Like would get sick if this person had gluten, and like it's no joke to, you know, if you have an allergy to this kind of thing, you have to you gotta look them dead in the eye and say, hey fucko,
fucko,
if you want a corpse in this chair,
I don't know why I'm letting you fucko the clown make my food, but listen here, fucko,
yeah.
It's a terrible chef name, by the way.
The no wheat pasta, and then we had gotten our food, and by the end of the meal, the person was like, "Yeah, I can start to feel that they definitely gave me the gluten thing," and then they had intestinal issues.
Yeah, that
was my understanding. That's like,
I couldn't imagine being a parent of a kid like that, because that's like. Parent on one end of like worrying about your kid dying from literally everything in the world, because that's the way that feels, because you're like, that thing is fucking vulnerable to the entire world, and then on top of that throw in like a, I don't know, fucking can't touch peanuts, and you're just like, oh god, if you fucking bring a peanut near my kid, I swear to god, Mary, I will cut you so deep.
Well, apparently you can at least with peanut allergies, you can actually get kids out of those now. I think it's like as babies or something, real right when they start able to eat solids.
Put them in a peanut bath at birth.
Well, it's
no, you have to like, it's like a, you have to build their tolerance up to it, something, right?
The iocane powder method,
peanut butter as their children, like really, really young, and that will give them that immunity to it. Whereas if you don't do that, they may or may not. It's a toss up, which is interesting. It's just kind of interesting, like, oh.
The thing I laughed at myself remembering, as I said, I don't have anyone in my immediate family or anyone that I knew of food allergies at all. I never even really realized that was a thing. Like I avoid sugar just because, and I don't know if it's an allergy or anything, but like I eat, you know, or I drink like a bit of a Coke that has real normal sugar in it versus like a Diet Coke, and I don't feel okay, and I'm gassy and gross, and I feel like I'm going to die for the next like 3 hours.
You have a thing about sugar?
Yeah, and that's been that way my entire life. Like,
Curley claims he ate sugar, bread, and milk.
Well, no, I mean, like, I don't know. So the bread thing and the milk thing, I mean, I don't drink milk at all because milk just is gross to me. But, like, the sugar thing is real. Like, I'll drink, like, I really wanted this cocktail, for instance, that this one place had, and it had, like, a sugar mix to it. And I was like, all right, whatever, I'll try it. And I was like, oh, fuck me. Like, that's but fucking not, the sugar.
It's not, like, a diabetes thing?
I don't know. I honestly don't know what diabetes feels like. I just get...
I mean, you would get a diagnosis.
Doctors can tell you.
I haven't been to a doctor in 10 years. I just get burpy, and I don't want to live anymore.
That sounds like maybe a thing you should go to the doctor for.
You but know? I also got this weird rash. It's red as hell, and it's just growing down my veins. Yeah, no.
Like, sometimes I pass out. Sometimes I just
black out for a few days. It's usually fine. But I wake up eventually.
Sure. Yeah.
Still alive. I just drink more liquor.
I just have like
anytime
a phone
you black
app
out
that'll
and you
buzz,
wake up, you're just sleeping.
It'll buzz for my boss to let them know that I'm unconscious and they need to reel me in.
I just don't eat it. That's the thing. And it's not like a big deal. Like, I just don't eat sugar as much as I can avoid it. I don't eat. When I make juices, I don't have oranges.
Oh my God,
whatever. Welcome to the channel, Brad, 1985. Brad, oh, breed, sorry. No, so the thing that made me giggle, though, is earlier, is that, again, not having anyone in my local, like group of people when I grew up having food allergies, never really was aware of it. Understood the concept of it, but never really was aware of it in general. So, fast forward to young, Curly, 19-year-old, maybe 20-year-old, working as a technician, going to schools, going to other places and everything, very specifically going to schools. And there's some classrooms, if anyone's been on a campus for classrooms, like elementary school, at least in California, they have these signs up for the, I guess, maybe they're the rooms that they put the peanut allergy kids in.
Say, that's totally a thing. Yeah.
Yeah. And there's like a sign that says like, you know, like no nuts. And it's like a picture of like the fucking monocle peanut guy. And I honestly thought for a long time that was just like telling kids to not be like silly. Like it was like, oh, no nuts in this classroom because you don't want to be like a silly crazy nut. I had no idea that was like a legitimate thing. And I mean, not like I brought a bag of peanuts to the classroom or anything, but I was just like, wow, this is that one room that's got the bad kids that are all nuts.
My God. I'd like to imagine, like, you're in one of those classrooms and you see a kid goofing off and you're like, man, you're going to get fucked up in, like, 2 minutes,
no,
bro.
No peanuts for you. Or no nuts.
No nuts.
I don't know. I didn't know. I had no idea. Oh. And it kind of clicked on me later and I was like, oh, because it's, like, nut allergies and I don't want fucking people, like, bringing their peanut butter sandwiches in and... Makes sense. Man.
The thing Curly just said always reminds me when I'm in the supermarket, and you can tell the dad who doesn't know, so he's always asking the kid, like, they're picking shit up, and he's like, are you allergic to that?
Oh, yeah. Those parents. The mom always knows, the kid knows really well,
or the weekend
the
parent.
The dad doesn't know.
Zero idea.
Well, because as a person who had... I mean,
but your sister can't eat the Captain Crunch? Which one is it? you're picking that up for you, right? But which one can... Right, we got to get one. I don't know what your sister...
Is it the Fruity Loops? The Fruity Loops.
Yeah, no.
Can you have the Cheerios? Can you have the Honey Nut? If I get you Cheerios, can you get the Honey Nut? Do you even know?
It's like seven types of Honey Nut here.
Do I get the off-brand?
So
off-brand okay?
As a person who was for a period of time...
I got a bag here for $3.99. We want that? No?
As a person who was... I was a parent of a kid that had a weekend dad, and... You make a good strong effort to make sure that out of all of the people in the world that need to know the information, the kid is the one that needs to know the information. But yeah, then we used to get calls from this guy, like Kaz just did, and he's just like, "Hey, I think Claire's lying to me. She says we need this special thing. It's like $7 more expensive than the other things, And they're like, yeah, no, because she can't eat the other thing. You understand? Like, she knows. Trust her on this. She's not trying to. She doesn't care. She doesn't have any concept of money right now, okay?
Yeah, kids don't exactly have, like, brand loyalty.
She knows that she's in trouble or going to not feel good if she eats the other one. Trust her on this.
Yeah.
That's the thing that would bother me is, like, the not trusting the kid. Yeah. Like, I can't eat that.
That's why he's
weakened. Well, you're just a child. You don't know any
That's
better.
Why he was weakened, Dad. That's why I was in the picture.
If I feed you this, are you going to die?
I don't know. Let's try it.
Let's see.
Oh, my God.
Let's see, child.
Oh, all right. Final game. I'm not in a place to play this anymore.
Like, I'm looking at these cards you made us draw, and I'm like, these are pretty random.
If you want to hold those up,
about the last hour and a half.
You're going to answer them, I'm gonna say a phrase, and you're going to answer by holding up one of those three cards. He's either going to say Yiddish, Klingon, or Bob Marley / Marmalade, according to Dan, because Dan, horse or Marmalade. Thank you, Sunbun. So this is a game, again, once again, stolen from NPR, so if any of you listen to it, please don't, cheat.
How would they...
Yeah, wait, if I listen to NPR and know the answers, how would I not cheat? Would I just step away from the game?
Exactly.
All right, I'm out. So yeah.
That's been Dan's time. Myself.
It was nice having...
So I'm going to read a bunch of clues. Each clue is a profound saying. The question is it either an old Yiddish proverb, an old Klingon proverb, or a Bob Marley lyric?
It's going to be hard.
This is bad.
So yeah, so for
discern the Bob Marley one.
For each phrase, just tell us, were these words from an old Eastern European language, a made-up Star Trek language, or a legendary Jamaican reggae singer?
Shit. The Bob Marley, I feel like the Bob Marley ones are going to be easy. The Yiddish or Klingon is going to throw me.
Who won the last game? Did I even take points? I forget.
I mean, I don't know. Kaz was all like, I'm just checking my power level. You know what I mean? I'm not going to play.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. Kaz took the whole sweeps in there.
I know. Fuck. Hey, I got two of those. You're taking it on his word that he knew, though.
True. He could have just been playing the long con. All right. First. Old profound saying.
All right.
When a worm sits in horseradish, it thinks there's nothing sweeter. Is that Yiddish, Klingon, or Bob Marley lyric?
Shit.
One more time.
When a worm sits in horseradish, it thinks there's nothing sweeter.
Can you say it in a Jamaican accent?
When the worm sits. Done.
God,
these are all real sayings. These are all real sayings in their perspective languages. I saw Dan with an answer.
Yeah.
Dan's got an answer. If someone wants to keep score in the chat, please do. Please. I need a scorekeeper.
That's a pretty high race.
Right. Oh, I'm sorry. You probably can't see that.
I can't see Bryce's. No, because it's backwards. You wanted to make sure that you... No, but earlier it was when you're holding it. Because
it was...
Oh, I got you. Well, you're doing the reveal. My bad. Sorry.
Can you see it through that?
Fucking Bryce is a professional, man.
Yeah.
I get it. No, I like it. I like the idea. All right. You are all correct. That is an old English proverb.
Klingons don't have horseradish.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Was a pretty easy.
They also don't have marmalade.
That was your introduction to this.
I'm ready for the next one to be like.
The next one.
Okay.
Never make a politician grant you a favor. They will always want to control you forever. You could do what Bryce was doing, where hold it backwards and then reveal at the end.
Okay. Never meet.
No woman, no cry.
Can you repeat it? Can you repeat it?
Never make a politician grant you a favor. They will always want to control you forever.
Can you say it in a Klingon accent?
I have no idea. I have no Klingon skills. Maybe I might have said something.
Oh, damn. Oh shit! Does it have an E in it? Fuck! Marley has an E in it.
All right.
Three, two, one. Reveal.
Gun Bob Marley.
That's a lot of Bob Marleys. You guys are all correct.
Woo! Hey!
Look at that. I don't know what song that's from, but
Klingons
fucking
don't have government.
probably just a quote from him because he was very into like anti. Yeah. I don't know.
It also rhymed a little bit.
A little bit, which is Bob Marley, right? Just a little bit.
Lyricist.
Next lyric. Bog-long. I mean, next fucking
Bob Marley. Next lyric. Bob Marley.
If you don't want to grow old, man. No, it's not. It's not. If you don't want to grow old, hang yourself when you're young. It's all Proverbs. Turn it around, Kaz, backwards.
No, hold on, I'm thinking.
If you don't want to grow old, hang yourself when you're young.
Can you say it like an old Jewish lady in a jewelry store?
I can't channel Fran Drescher at this point.
If you don't want to grow old, don't kill your...
Kill yourself now.
Kill yourself now.
I mean, that sounds fucking...
I'm gonna go Klingon because Klingons are really like hardcore about their like. Oh
but
shit!
I'm gonna say well.
This is why you do the reveal instead of just showing it.
Well,
yeah,
because you're taking cast now.
I was doing the reveal, but then
I'm sticking with Klingon.
Saying
it.
So. Klingons. That's a coward's way out for a war-y tribe.
Oh. So it is Yiddish, in fact. Kaz is down one.
God damn it! As soon as Dan said
we're
that,
we're
going to
go
like,
with Kaz negative one.
Way out. Can't kill yourself.
Shit!
Logical.
I didn't watch enough TNG.
You did not.
Next quote. Death in his. Oh, sorry. Ugh. I just.
What are you doing, Curley?
I have. I don't want to go too gross.
Okay.
I have a bit of a like lodged sniffle that I cannot blow. I've been trying to blow out of my nose for the entire episode, and it's bugging the shit out of me. And so every now and then I'm like,
the other end,
and it's killing me inside. So I was just I was in the middle of talking at that moment, and I couldn't breathe. I was like, ah,
Loktar, like
Loktar, Ogar. That's Warcraft, yeah.
That's Warcraft. Those are orcs.
Well done.
Look. I know that shit. Oh, give me orc or
dude. I went in to see Star Wars drunk.
I still have not seen that movie. I went
to it with Erica. In the one of the trailers is the Warcraft movie.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Really.
And I was in there with my hands up like this with Erica next to me, and I was like, look, Dar! Oh, I was like, yeah. I am so pumped for this right now. That's good times. Zug, zug. Yeah. Low. Anyways, the next one is death is an experience best shared.
I'm ready for the reveal. Mm.
Yiddish, Klingon, or Bob Marley lyric.
Can you say it like Captain Janeway?
Captain Janeway is the captain you go to.
I loved Voyager. No, Voyager is my favorite.
Really?
I get a lot of hate for that. But dude, I loved Voyager.
I have not actually sat down and watched Voyager. I'm
there with you, Dan. I'm there with you.
I went and spent the time with my ex, and we watched all of the original series and the Next Generation.
Yeah, TNG's really good, too, but I grew up on Voyager. Anyway, I'm ready.
Yeah. I'm ready.
Loktar, turn it! That is a Klingon. Of course, that is a Klingon. Death in his experience, best shard.
Though I was a little conflicted because the Jewish people sit. Was it Shiva? When somebody dies, and so they spend a week just sitting together. If Reeds has taught me anything, well, it's a Jewish thing.
Is it a Klingon thing?
No, they just want you to die together, like in battle.
Okay. Oh, that's a good. That's actually that makes more sense.
Yeah, like being with your friend, dying together.
Valiantly.
You can't empty the ocean with a spoon.
Ooh. What's that? Can you,
You cannot empty the ocean with a spoon.
Can you say it like the monster from Cloverfield?
You can eat a cookie. It's too soon.
Can't empty the ocean with a spoon.
And so it's like, which ocean?
Yeah, right? It's got it. Oceans
can you tell are us which ocean?
Oceans are oceans, man. It's not the Sea of Tranquility.
How many more of these you got? Because I'm running out of characters.
No woman, no cry.
All right.
People think that's a fucking genius for some reason.
Okay, I think I'm ready.
Go ahead. That is...
Oh!
A Yiddish saying.
No!
Well Hold done! On.
Though, gamer me, I did see the
So God. Is it Kaz yeah. and Nesh, or Bryce, yeah. are both one down.
Yeah. But you're trying to say Cloverfield 2.
Cloverfield 2, yes.
It's in the sentence. It's like, it's in the word
I,
that...
I fucking understood it, and then in my brain, it went...
You smell toast.
Do I smell toast?
I keep smelling gummy bears, and it's really
It's because your upper lip at this point. Next quote, or next proverb.
That beard somewhere.
The hotter the battle... The sweeter the victory.
Oh.
Easy.
Yeah.
Okay, turn it. That is a Bob Marley quote.
Ah!
Good. No, I'm glad we all got that wrong.
I was like, because for me, I'm not a Bob Marley fan, and I was like, man, they're fucking going to know that's like that one big song that everyone listens to or something. No, hotter battle, sweeter victor.
You know they're not all from his songs, right?
They're lyrics. They're not.
Are you sure?
Oh, the way this game is played, Yiddish proverb, Klingon proverb, or Bob Marley lyric.
Oh.
He made the game, Kaz.
That is a lyric in the fucking...
It's fucking... It's also Curley, so there's like a 9% chance that he wrote them wrong.
Which...
excuse me. Again, game stolen. Transcriptions done by the NPR people. Okay, so
I want to talk to these people.
Next one, which is your last question, which is either going to make Dan the winner, or
tie.
Actually,
you, I either win or tie. If, I can't lose.
You can't lose. Yeah, you're the winner. Tie. All right. Here goes. It's easier. It might be a three-way tie at this point if you guys both beat Dan. You cannot loosen a man's tongue with root beer. One again, because Kaz is giving me a weird face. You cannot loosen a man's tongue with root beer.
Can you say it like...
I'm not saying it in any fucking special way.
Damn it, I just thought of another character.
Fuck it. Can you say it like Patty Mayonnaise?
You want to do that?
You say it like Bubbles from the Powerpuff Girls.
No, no, woman, no. Turn your cards.
You thought about it.
Yeah, I took a second. I was like, no,
it's Tara Strong.
Yeah, it is Tara Strong. Not anymore.
Oh, they fucking bounced her.
They changed them.
They all new cast with the exception of Tom Kenny, who's reprising his roles.
Side. Okay.
Anyway, oh God.
You know the weird thing? Before they even mentioned redoing the Powerpuff Girls, I was sitting here the other day, and I was playing Heroes or League or something, and it all of a sudden I was just like, him was a fucked up character.
He's not fucked up.
He's just.
I love him so much.
It's so weird because it's such a counterculture thing. Like anyone else at that time, especially at that time period, would
that
have
show. Was really ahead of its time.
But I think everyone was like, yeah, no, he's fucking cool. Like, whatever. Like, everyone I knew at younger kids.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking about back in that time period, like, if I had shown that to my parents, they'd have been like, the fuck are you watching? Like, it's not okay.
So, hold on, right? So, this was the thing that made me mad the other day. And I don't know how I got in this rabbit hole, but I was looking at, like, YouTube Reacts things.
And Kaz is trying to stall for fucking Google right now at this point.
No. I can't. It's right here. I was looking at like YouTube React things, and I got to a YouTube this person's name reacts to adult jokes in 90s cartoon shows, and I was like, yeah, okay, that.
Want to fight about it? Like, Jesus.
Right. And I'm just like, and they're like watching cartoons, and it's like, oh, I remember like it was like one of the Powerpuff Girls ones, and fucking redheaded lady is just like, oh, I don't remember the last time I was tied up like this. And the dude's like, oh man, whoa. And I'm just like, yes, it's a show for children, but it's not written by children. It is written by adults. So of course there are going to be some adult themed jokes snuck in there.
You have to extrapolate that back to before you as well. The cartoons that started were not necessarily the idea of a drawn piece of art wasn't immediately children based. And so you look at some of the older cartoons or some of the original cartoons, some of the old, you know, what Chuck Jones shit, and there's some fucking adult goddamn themes going on in shenanigans, and it's only hidden and veiled away because that's the way society was as well. They you don't just immediately say, you know, this kind of vulgar thing or whatever. They kind of like veil it behind some kind of like threat or common like vernacular or whatever. And so there's a lot of really like horrible shit Popeye said to olive oil in some old cartoons that I watched, and I'm like, oh, but it's like thinly veiled, and you're like, well, man, he's
that no pup, you want no, olive oil.
There's a couple where he's like obviously domestically abusing fucking olive oil, and you're like, holy crap, like Jesus. And then like, but then they replay them at like, you know, late night Cartoon Network, and you watch it and you're like, oh, I guess it's okay now because that's fine.
Well, I mean, you've seen the notes that Looney Tunes will have, like with some of their more racially charged cartoons, and they'll have that disclaimer of, this is a piece of the time. We know this isn't okay now.
Oh, do they do that now?
Yeah, they do.
I haven't gone back and seen stuff since.
Yeah, you'll see that. Like with, I mean, there are the ones that were released around World War II specifically are bad.
The ones where Daffy Duck is Hitler or something like
Daffy
that.
Daffy Duck is Hitler. They've got like really, really, really bad Japanese caricatures.
Yes, I'm pretty sure.
Anytime they show Japanese people, anytime they show Indians, anytime they show fucking, God forbid, just any fucking black person.
Yeah, oh yeah. The Bugs Bunny with the black hunter, that one was real bad.
Yeah. And those were shown pretty actively, as I remember.
I remember seeing that one a number of times as a kid.
I still love Speedy Gonzalez's like lazy cousin. Like the slow fucking Mexican. Speedy, it's okay. We don't have to do so much today.
Name like Pedro or something.
Yeah,
like,
he's like, no,
I'm super stereotypical name.
He's like, yeah, I would love to do the. You know, I'm gonna get the cheese later, but I'm gonna sleep for a moment.
Oh, Sun Button just linked it.
Yeah, there it is. That's what I was talking about.
These we're about to see are a product of.
Are
their
we
time.
Showing? Are we able to show
this? No, it's just a disclaimer.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's great. Yeah. That's good that they do that, I guess.
Yeah, they do. Yeah. It's good.
What's the only Disney movie that's not in the vault? The big, like, redone Blu-ray vault is the Dumbo shit? Because the fucking...
The Scarecrows?
No, the fucking Ravens.
Ravens, yeah.
I done seen Jim, about everything, but I ain't never seen Jim an elephant
Crows.
Fly. Yeah, the Jim Crows.
The Jim Crows.
Yeah.
The Crows.
I don't know, man. I think that's art in its fucking time period, and it was a voice in its time period, and it's important. Like, I don't know.
Anyway. I don't know. I love that shit, but I find it funny for a specific reason, but whatever.
3, 2, 1, turn your... Oh, go back. It's fine. You cannot loosen a man's tongue with root beer. Cass, turn your shit. You're trying to change it. We've got a Bob Marley, a Yiddish, and a Bob Marley. So what is it? So we need Dan to lose one.
No,
we have to get it right.
If it's Bob Marley, we all win or we all tie. If it's not Bob Marley, then
the beautiful thing is Kaz and Bryce have both picked opposite, or they both picked together, and Dan picked a different thing.
Yeah,
which means this very well could be that Dan is the loser and Bryce and
people are putting it together. Curley,
I'm already one ahead, so it's either we all tie or nothing,
or you win.
Yeah.
Yes. So, if, for example, if the correct answer is Bob Marley, then Kaz and I will have the same number of points as Dan, leading in what game theorists call a tie.
So I just realized I was working on the idea of you losing a point if you got one wrong.
I know
my own mistake. I know my own mistake.
Then I would win regardless.
But that's how the numbers were working in my head.
I would only win at this point if that was the case, Curley.
Now let's talk about bonus stars.
You guys didn't know that there was going to be slowest. Who had the quickest and bluest paper.
Oh, Dan's waving his little blue paper around.
All right, anyways, the answer for you cannot loosen a man's tongue with root beer is, in fact, you're all wrong, Klingon. It's a Klingon saying. Because Star Trek is ridiculous.
The Klingons didn't have root beer. That's bullshit.
Well, no, they did. They did on like the ships, and that was probably like Worf or something.
You think any other culture besides humans created a beer made of roots? Come on.
No.
Well, a non-alcoholic beer made of roots, perhaps.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Bullshit.
Mm-hmm. I mean there's the whole thing they were talking about on another podcast, where the whole idea of like you just say a liquor and then an alien race before it and it makes it like exotic in Star Wars, Star Trek. Jesus Christ.
A Valorian cocktail.
Yeah. So you're just like, yeah, like the Klingon ale from the stars of Dunegrave. Like, oh yes, this Klingon ale from Dunegrave. You're like be like Romulan ale from the quad sector. It took three
quad
men's lives
does have
to
particularly tasty ale.
Romulans would know how to make a stiff drink, given their shenanigans.
So Dan wins.
So that's it. Dan wins.
The blood off of his hands.
After all this,
destroying us.
I wish there was a quick.
You can do it. I know you can. No, you're a man.
You can do it. Curly.
It's all right. A little bit more. Am I still recording? Yeah. Okay.
You better be recording. Actually, I don't care. You know, in all honesty. Oh, shit. Choco, please. That is for you, Dan. They do move in herds.
Sometimes it's longer.
It's never. It's always the same.
No, man. Some days it fucking goes on.
It depends on how much you've had to drink. It really does. The more you drink, the worse it is.
Oh man, I understand why people. No, I ain't gonna say it.
Awesome. Anyways, that is the end of my game. And I think that can... Oh, shit. Mails. Let's check if we have any mails. I didn't even look at this point. Do any mails today?
Well, I don't know. I have access show. To that.
You got four. Damn it, Dan. God damn you.
The jokes. The jokes.
Gotta be quick.
All right, we do.
Just slightly too slow.
Time for some cocktail-infused communications.
DKGWELP.
Email.
Now!
And we have one from MJM, who says he can't even. He sent it to buttstuff@dkgtv.com. When it comes to Netflix, I like to put on some stand-up comedy and begin my work. What's your favorite? Who's your favorite stand-up comedy? Comic.
Who's your favorite?
I have had a lot of whiskey. Who's your favorite stand-up comic? All the best, MJM.
John Mahoney is my most recent favorite.
John Mahoney?
Yeah.
No idea who that is.
He's one of the writers of Parks and Rec.
Oh.
Hilarious man. He's got two stand-up bits on Netflix right now. So that's very relevant to the person enjoying Netflix. Very, very funny. Very, very funny man.
I really like John Mulaney.
Mulaney, damn it! I always do that. Thank you.
Oh my god. You played that so smoothly. Damn!
Well, part of it was like, there could totally be a John Mahoney who has two Netflix specials.
That's for you, bro. Well done.
All right.
Oh, damn.
Mulaney. Yes, him. Mulaney. My wife corrects me every time, too.
I didn't know he wrote for Parks and Rec.
Yeah, he was a Parks and Rec writer, I'm pretty sure.
Oh, wow.
Well, let's see.
Yeah. His stand-up specials are really great, the two on Netflix. I also like Paul F. Tompkins and, like, Andy Daly, but they do a lot of podcasting stuff. So, like, on Comedy Bang Bang or Spontaneation, which is Paul's podcast, those are pretty great.
Not Parks and Rec. SNL. Sorry.
Yes, SNL. You're probably thinking of Harris Whittles, who passed away.
Yes, that's what I was thinking of.
Oh, man. See, all right, here's the problem for me.
Oh, God, there's just a lot answer the for, question, God damn it.
And see, there's a lot more stand-up comedians I don't like than stand-up comedians that I could
automatically... Why does your mind go immediately negative?
Just pick two!
Go with what you like!
Fuck.
I don't give a shit what you don't like.
Eddie Murphy used to be funny. I really like George Carlin.
Yeah, Carlin's great.
He's boring as fuck to me.
Your mom.
shit, motherfucker.
It's not a surprise. I've watched Carlin shit and I'm like, yeah, you're boring me, old man. I'm sure I know and I respect that you, just like the Beatles, like, I'm like, sure, yeah, you moved the genre forward. You're also now boring to me.
Well, yeah, it is. It's a product of the time, right?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like, you go back and read his books and it's like, man, this is 200 pages of an old man griping. And it's like, I'm not in that mode. I'm not in that mental state anymore.
It's like when my grandpa tried to teach me how to knife fight. And I'm like, you're an old man. I can just beat you in the face with my fists.
Or when my grandpa asked me if there were blacks at my school.
Yeah. Yes, grandpa. Sorry. There are a couple of blacks.
That was a legit question that was asked from my grandpa to me. Yep.
Kaz, where'd you go?
That was when I really know. That's when I knew that he was a terrible racist. That was the day.
My family tried.
Was that where we're going? No, my grandpa did racist? Not try.
No, he tried. They tried to go along with the changing times. Like
not my grandpa. My grandma was amazing with it. Not my grandpa.
There was a lot of every single time it wasn't someone that was of some white descent, Irish or Scottish or whatever. Like every single person up to my just the parental units was every single time anyone was mentioned that wasn't white was, hey, yeah, no, I just got back from Blockbuster. The store clerk, he's a black guy, totally nice, actually.
Oh,
every single thing is that, and so they tried, but they always had to preface anytime that it was anyone of any kind of background of non-white was no, but he was really good. He did his job great every single time, and I'm like, why do you feel the need? God damn it! It was so frustrating
You're pointing out your racism.
And
in their
great guy, Chinese valet, great guy.
Right. Well, in their mind, they're compromising and they're saying, oh, the Chinese valet, he totally didn't crash my car or anything. Yeah. Right. Like, that's their compromise.
They think they're doing amazing things for that.
Yeah.
He totally wasn't on crack. Yeah.
Right.
He didn't rob me or anything.
He acted like a human being. I was surprised, as I would be. But, you know, it turned out okay. I'm here today to have dinner. Thanks.
So, like, for me, my father is that person, right? Because he's very old, black, southern man or whatever. So, like, all white people hate him, and, you know, he hates all white people. So, like, you know, we grew up in New York, and we grew up in a very mixed, you know, family neighborhood. So I had, like, you know, friends of, like, you know, the rainbow, because that was the theme of the 90s. And I just remember very specifically, there was this little Asian girl that I used to hang out with, and he'd be like, she speaks English? I'm like, why wouldn't she? Like, he's like, oh, all right.
Yeah.
And I'm just like, then you're like, when my friends come, go somewhere. Just don't be here. Like, just don't be here because I can't explain you. I can't. Like, you're harshing my vibe.
The large amount of confusion and curiosity, like, from the entire family when I brought a Filipino girl to dinner, and it was just like, did she just come over? Like, what is? And I'm like, no, their family's been here for so long. Longer than your family has been here. Like, it's just, what is, why?
There aren't even like a lot of Filipino, thank you. Like stereotypes. Are there?
It's more about the food they eat. I mean, I'm not going to lie. I wasn't happy with trying to eat the fucking duck embryos. Cause that was fucking crazy. So fuck that. I don't like beak.
Yeah, sure.
That wasn't a racism thing. Beak. It was just like, I don't want this. I know you think it's delicious. This is gross to me. I'm sorry.
Whatever. No, I've also very recently had the experience of being told, like, you know, at some point, I'm dating a person of Chinese descent, and they're like, oh, you have to meet my parents, and they're like, they're going to be racist.
Just letting you know. I need to. Yeah. Well, it was kind of. It sounds terrible because I loved my grandpa dearly, but like it was kind of convenient that he passed before I married my wife. Because she's Japanese, 100%. But she's American. I mean, she's like full American. So like it would have not gone.
But you're not sure what you're going to get. You're either going to get like kind of understanding but a little bit rude, or full-on Cotton Hill, you know, like
it would have been full-on Cotton Hill because he didn't know. It would have,
okay,
he just straight up didn't go to my cousin's wedding when she married a black man. Just 100% refused.
I feel like we're doing great though. Given the all-encompassing amount of time that the universe has, we're moving forward pretty quickly. Think, right?
Yeah, in the grand scheme of things, sure. Yeah.
So looking at my family, which I've explained just now, the one that started it all was my great grandmother, who died a couple years back, like 7 years back, like 90 something, and this lady, this piece of work, was very nice, but. No, she wasn't. No, I'm sorry. I want to say
don't
that.
Justify it. Yeah, just
she,
don't justify it.
She, so I am one of the first of the family to not be born in wedlock. Didn't know what that meant as a kid, obviously.
Sure.
But so I was brought to Christmas dinners because, you know, whatever. My grandmother, who was only one down from her, she actually, like, she was very into the church as well, but she lied to the church to get me baptized. I got baptized in a Catholic, like a fire and brimstone crazy Catholic, as a bastard child, because my grandmother lied. She risked her immortal soul, as far as she's concerned, to get me baptized. That being said, that wasn't enough for my great-grandmother. My great-grandmother would not acknowledge my existence in front of anyone else. at dinner...
She fought and lied to get you back.
No, my grandmother did.
Great grandma. Okay.
So my grandmother's one down from that, and even though she was still very fire and brimstone Catholic and still, like, you know, is very, like, concerned. I have, like, I have a 40-year-old aunt who just broke up with her divorce. husband who she wasn't happy with, and she's now, like, you know, playing the field and living her life. And I had this conversation, like, randomly with my grandmother, and I'm like, oh my god, it's cool. She's like, she just turned 40. She's totally young. Like, I've met plenty of friends that are, like, still, you know, like living their life large and finding out who they are and everything. Like, Trisha's gonna be fine. Sorry, Trisha, I brought your name up. But my grandmother looked at me like I was a ghost and was like, oh, she's an old maid now. And I'm like, she's 40 years old, bitch. She has time. Okay? She's fine.
She's going to live another 40, 50 years average.
But my great-grandmother, again, did not acknowledge that I existed. I was a ghost in the household. She would not look at me if she tripped over me when I was a kid. Except she and her, and I don't know if this was some kind of justification for her. She would find me when I was alone, and she would give me like a Christmas present.
Pee on you. Oh,
as long, no, as long as it wasn't in front of everyone else.
Yeah.
She thought she loved me. She thought I was fantastic, but she would not acknowledge me in front of others because I was a bastard child.
Wait, I thought you started this off that you were the only one that wasn't a bastard.
No, I was, I was the only bastard child.
Well, only kid not born in wedlock. Yeah.
Yeah.
In wedlock.
And so, yeah, so I was not allowed to be acknowledged.
That's an old school. That's an old school. Well,
she again, she died at like 98. Like, she was an old lady. She definitely, yeah. Again, but like, as far as I was concerned as a kid, she was great because we would hang out and like talk and have a good time as my young 5-year-old mind can remember. But she
definitely, weren't friends in public, though.
No, but from she what I the, from what I learned is what I learned it was like, oh, that's why it was always in the back computer room or the room that was like for the sewing machine and shit at that time period.
Which is so weird because who gives a fuck?
Yeah, but you say that as a young person now, but you know, you 3 generations, 4 generations yeah, back.
It did matter.
It's frightening. I was the reason why our family name was getting dragged through the mud. You know, like, God forbid. Like, I've been watching a lot of Downton Abbey, okay, guys? I don't know. it's funny to see.
Yeah, no, I love fucking old racism. It's good shit.
It's terrifying. To me, honestly, the idea is terrifying because...
No, it is terrifying, and the only reason I can find enjoyment in it is because of the time and age in which we live now, right? Yeah. So, like, I can look at that shit, and I can look at some 80-year-old dude who looks at me and he's like, "Remember when you used to have to wash my car?" And I'm like,
"Well, so that's what I wanted to mention is I look at it and I'm like, I think great grandmother, superb racism, grandpa, very racist, Dad, he's got a smidge in there. He's still a little working through it. Me, I mean, I don't know. I'm pretty confident. I don't understand my privilege all the time, and I fucking let shit go and laugh. But you know, for the most part, I think I'm pretty advanced in my
and it's relative,
stuff, right?
Right? Like, you will probably be in some very niche history book. Will probably be written as worse than we all think we are right now because like it will just get better over time.
My grandfather was on Twitch TV and he had a slave friend run it. I heard he didn't even pay him any money to run the majority of his shows.
And he still insulted him. What sort of mess was that?
They thought it was so fun. They had a command to show racism as a joke.
Oh,
I mean,
crap.
This poor boy couldn't read, and he just tore into him.
Oh, Christ. Oh, Jesus, I love it.
Boy.
Just to top that off, I'm going to go ahead and leave it on...
Oh, your email.
There it is. Hey!
Took him a minute. He found it.
I think that creates a real unrealistic standard of beauty for domestic Dans everywhere. Mm-hmm.
No, that's about spot on, to be fair.
Really?
I wish I could show this to my great-grandmother. No, it's a friend of mine I work with. It's great.
Oh, man. Fuck. Ooh, I just got hit with an issue. All right, never mind.
So we were finishing off email. Sorry.
I want to know what's up with Kaz's butt. Kaz, what's going on?
Good? My butt's fine. The thought of racism and explaining things to family just hit me. Like, yeah. Okay. Explaining why my Chinese girlfriend doesn't have a veve but has a pepe, but is a girl.
Yeah. Did anyone teach you the real words for
genitals? They did, but I like the ones I used.
So you like being 7 years old all the time.
Yeah, I do.
Got it.
I do.
This is why the history books will write negatively on you, guys.
Yeah. There are some things I've said in YouTube videos that are
If you
out
want
there.
To answer this one question, it's from Very Bad Gamer. My question is, what would the DKG, the movie, be like? What would the plot be? Who would direct it? Who would you cast as you?
Tay Diggs.
I would cast. If I could cast Tay Diggs as Kaz, I would replace him right now. I mean, no offense, Kaz. I'm sorry.
Well, see, here's how this would go, right? I'd want Tay Diggs, but I'd get stuck with Tyrese or like Martin Waynes.
You get one of the Waynes brothers, one of like the Waynes cousins.
I feel like maybe I feel like Kevin
Lamar
Hart
Waynes
justice, right? Like,
no, he's so fucking short and like weird.
Dude, you're on a fucking webcam. No one knows how tall you are.
That's true.
5'11".
I'm gonna go straight up with a fan service here. I would just replace myself with Guy Fieri. There you go.
Oh my god!
Shut the fuck up! I hate you so much, Red. Oh, I'm so done. I'm shutting this show down. This has been DKG. Welp, episode 30. Cut it. I hate you so much, Red.
Benedict Cumberbatch for Dan.
No. Someone better than that.
I mean, that's a pretty kind thing for you to say. Okay. I mean, like, do you want, like, when you're in Seattle next?
Just because you wouldn't touch him doesn't mean everybody else.
True. I, on the other hand, would either be cast as my doppelganger from
Kylo
HBO.
Ren?
God damn it, Lo Ren all over my fucking shit. God damn it. Go. He's either going to be Kylo Ren or Josh Brenner, who looks exactly like me.
What's that guy who's not the guy who was in Facebook, but looks like the guy who was in the Facebook movie?
Jesse Eisenberg? What?
Yeah!
I think he was in the Facebook movie.
Yeah, he was.
Then, no.
Mark Zuckerberg.
What's the...
He was in Scott Pilgrim.
How did I lose his name? Come on back to me. Michael Cera. That's Scott Pilgrim. I don't know why you're saying like, but yeah. That's
Scott Pilgrim and Jesse Eisenberg, they're kind of the same like weird pasty white kids.
Mm. Yeah. Mm. Yeah. Yeah. Director. Ooh, shit. That's a rough one. Because they're like
JJ Abrams.
It's too much lens flare for a fucking chuckle fuck movie. It would be
who is accustomed to making very long, unnecessarily long films.
J.J. Abrams.
I don't know what a domestic Dan lookalike is. I'm blanking on this. Like, let's try the celebrity.
Joshua Topolsky.
I don't know who that is.
That's
the Verge former, dude.
Yeah, he was formerly from The Verge.
The website?
Yeah, he's a news guy. He's not an actor. But he's been on camera, so I think it counts.
Jesse Topolsky?
Joshua Topolsky.
Topolsky.
Oh my god.
Oh, that's a good looking man. All right.
Oh, hey.
Yeah.
See, I mean, I would say Terry Gilliam, but then that's just dumb.
Yeah, but I say Dan beat. I mean, Dan makes a better him.
No, his face is a little too long for me, but you know.
Yeah.
My face is actually, I have a tiny head. This beard hides it. It's great.
Yeah.
Like, my chin ends up here.
Mm-hmm.
Last time I shaved, I was just like, what the hell? Where'd my face go?
Oh, fuck! I forgot a story. God damn it. All right.
We're on the tail end.
No. You need to fucking see this right now. Okay. Japanese people built a robot that you can drink with. Or not Japanese, but Korean people.
Yeah, I saw that. The shower with you.
Whole thing, you fucking came at me with fucking Kaz and his robot stories, and then you fucking spin back around with, no. Hey, are you fucking lonely? Can none of your friends fucking drink? Are you fucking sad? Are the calendar years over? Do you still want to go to a fucking bar and watch the fucking Patriots game?
Kaz,
a bunch of hired robots to do.
Kaz,
fucking
please.
Shit.
This is why I had the story prepped. That's why all of the things I said were leading up to me bringing up a story of a Korean robot. All the times that I called you out for your robot stories were literally build up to the fact that I would bring a robot story to the table. I was trying to make it a fucking full thing. This is why you shouldn't drink, kids. It's fucking bad. Anyways, if you've ever been sad and drank alone, apparently I don't have that problem. I drink alone all the time. But this man, he decided, and this is roughly translated using Google Translate, he found out that one day in 2012, he was drinking soju, which is, I guess, Korean alcohol, alone.
Yeah.
And he had found it to taste terrible. And he was like, why does this taste terrible? I usually love this drink. And so he put a drink in front of him and pretended that he was cheersing to a friend and then drank it. And it tasted better, in his opinion. And so he was like, oh, you know what? Alcohol is basically a group activity. And I want to make a robot that you can drink with. And so he made this guy. Drinky.
Yeah.
Oh
God. Yep.
Yo, I love that.
The hat is amazing.
It clinks the damn shot with you.
You pour the drink into it. It detects that there's a drink in it.
I like how it's like,
hook it up, bro.
Give me the drink, bro.
Here, bro.
And it waits for you to clink.
You clink, and then you go, and he goes
and
in.
It and drinks. Oh my God, it has a mouth, and it fills the container.
And it goes to the container so you can save your drink for later. Yeah. And then he turns all red and enjoys himself.
And then he blushes.
Yeah. And he thumbs up you, bro, and he's great.
I will say that video sums up my time that I actually spent in Korea. Those are the only parts I remember. Oh, I'm in a hotel.
He is a very nice dude. I honestly went into it with the idea of like, all right, this is a joke story about a fucking crazy Korean robot. But the guy's got a website that he has the links to all of his robot stuff, open source, ready for you to use. And he's just making cool robot shit as a Korean dude. And I love him. I kind of fucking found my new favorite Korean.
I will say, who is it before?
Who's your favorite
Korean before this?
Yeah, I'm curious. I'm just curious.
Oh, I guess you said new favorite Korean. Previous new favorite or old favorite Korean. The dude Gunwoo who plays the guy. Well, I don't know his name. The guy who plays Gunwoo in My Sassy Girl, which is a Korean.
Cha Tae-hyun.
You are either Rain Man or you're faking it.
No, he's on a
Rain is another man. It's not Rain is a different guy.
Rain is lovely. Oh my God.
But do you
God.
Know the guy who plays the male lead in My Sassy Girl?
Yeah, I do. Because he's on a variety show that I watch.
So that guy was my previous favorite Korean dude.
Okay, cool.
Lovely children. Like
I absolutely fun. Like I for the past 10 years that guy has been like my hero. I love him so much.
Yeah. No. I very much know who that is.
Thank you. Because that would look really shitty for me if you didn't know his name. Because I didn't. I mean, he was my favorite Korean. I just knew him by one acting appearance.
Let me see.
But yeah, so if you look.
That little robot. I expected like a big Osimo sort of like human size robot. Like,
He made. He did a bunch of stuff for Maker Faire. Like, if you look at his like website, he's got a bunch of shit. He made a robot that plays a drum. Which is adorable. This little adorable robot that plays the drums. It's cute. It's just adorable. And all of his stuff that he builds for these robots, by the way, if you look at it, they're all from his little 3D printer.
Yeah, I see that.
Aren't you happy to live in this world that we live in? Come on. Like, come on. How could you ever be sad when you can make this in your house for less than like $1,000?
Mm-hmm. Pet vet, talk to me. I will give you a list of Korean things to watch.
My Sassy Girl.
I have a whole other podcast based on Korean things.
Watch The Classic if you ever want to fucking cry a lot. It's great.
I've only seen one Korean drama most of the way through. And I don't even know if I'm going to remember the name.
Okay.
I probably won't. It's a very stereotypical one. And it's like mother and daughter and daughter's... What was it?
My Sam Lovely Sam?
That's exactly it, yeah.
God damn it, Kaz!
No, I knew it was a really popular one. So but Kaz has it, yes. Thank you, Kaz. That's it. Yeah, that's the one I've seen.
I don't... I'm pretty open-minded about when I just don't know something. right? Mm-hmm. Like, I'm like, okay, that's something that I don't know that's outside of my sphere. But
yes,
K-pop and K-dramas are the things that make me feel like I'm missing something. Something big is happening, and I have no fucking clue.
See,
we very much, you've been on my Korean podcast, and we talked about this, because you have a good knowledge of Japanese stuff.
Like Japanese music sometimes, music. Yeah.
And like, but just that little step over into Korean stuff hasn't hit you, you know?
No, and it's a huge step, and it requires a lot. It would require me, I don't know. Like, it almost feels like selling out. I don't...
Yeah,
no, it's so good.
And I'm not trying to hate on anybody. Y'all are doing your thing and loving Rain and the Chiwon 2 guy. But...
So, my introduction, I might have just been, like, got lucky with it. But I got, thanks to a girl I was dating, the classic is the first movie I ever watched. It was a Korean drama movie, love story, whatever. And yes. Apparently it's based off of like a very popular Korean like motif of the farm boy and or the farm boy and girl, and one goes off to war, and you know, it's all about, yep, you know the parents don't want it to happen, but it's the star-crossed lovers and all the stuff that's ever happened in every fucking, you know, genre. That being said, it's beautiful.
A lot in Korean dramas is like rich person, poor person.
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of class systems going on. Yeah,
yeah.
So I liked it. It was okay. It was a good quote unquote love story for whatever. And then you look at My Sassy Girl, which is my favorite, easily my favorite Korean fucking thing ever. And it's they make fun of the classic constant. There's actually like a scene because the female lead at some point is just like, she's like putting this guy through his paces and his tests and like seeing how much he's dedicated. And she's like, I write stories here. Like, I want you to act this out. And she's like, and he's like, no, I don't want to do it. You're fucking violent with your shit. And it's like one of the stories she writes out is the story. Basically, it's literally making fun of the classic. And it's she like, so they do this video like flashback sort of flash montage thing where that's the main character, and he's like the farm boy, and he's like trying to like woo this girl, and he finally woos her, but he promises her that he will forever live for with her no matter what happens, and he will die when she dies, and she ends up dying of something, and they like the lawyers take it as literal that he said that. And so she's like, and the young, and so she's like reading the story to him, and he's like horrified, and she's like, and the young boy was buried alive with her body, and like in the thing, and he's like freaking out. He's like, "This girl's crazy!"
Like, and it's like a flash to him, like the like the old times. And they throw him.
Yeah,
in the
grave. They like all the villagers throw him in the pit with her because they have to follow the law. They're throwing dirt on his face, and he's like, "No, please, I'm alive."
About that, because like I said, he's on this variety show that I watch every week, and the girl who was in the movie with him was a guest, and they were talking about it, and he's like, that scene where they throw me in the he's like it's a fun scene, he's like, but we had to do it two times, and he's like, then there's the one time they threw me in and the guy starts to shovel, but he's like, I stand up so he has to hit me, but I stood up too quick and he just hits me straight in the head, so he's like, I just dropped down. It's great. It's good shit.
Good. If you ever need, if you never did anything, yeah. I have the. We're gonna do Sassy Girl one movie night, one DKG movie night, for sure.
I am down.
Did I miss Rockadoodle?
So we were, our first movie night was going to be Rockadoodle, but the whole David Bowie, Alan Rickman thing happened.
Oh yeah.
With the passing, so we watched Labyrinth and we watched Galaxy Quest. Mm. Which are just phenomenal movies. Solid. And in all honesty, there's going to be I'm going to post something at some point. We had a fucking hoot that night. And I feel bad for anyone that missed it because we just had a good time. It was popcorn.
Go subscribe to Patreon. You could be a part of that.
Yeah. It's a great thing. It's much more intimate than any of the 24-hour live streams that I ever tried to do. It's much more entertaining, much more intimate, much more enjoyable, in my opinion, than anything we've ever done. It's offline, obviously. It's not offline. It's off Twitch because we can't illegally watch movies here.
You could live. Not that you could do like a riff tracksy thing.
Right. Yeah.
You know, everybody hit play at the same time.
Yeah, or like that's what we're doing. Tube. That's what we're doing.
There
are ways. But that being said, yeah, this has been a great episode. I love you guys, dude. This has been fun. That's the end of mailbag time.
Yeah.
And the end of the show in general. Because it's been 2 hours. Easily.
Yeah.
I would definitely like to thank our guests so they can go home. Bryce, you can check out at Bryce or on twitch.tv/Bryce, or you can go to NeshCon.
So you see how they're on the screen? You see how they're on the screen?
It's written down. See, look, I understood it last time when it was NeshCon because I didn't say anything, and also I go by NeshCon. But it's written, it's Brycas, Brycas. You were saying Bryce.
It's if you want to follow Brycecast.
Throw a T in there.
Brycecast.com. Where all your Neshes can be found.
It's your fucking domains. Bry Nesh. You can go there for his unreleased tracks. You can go to Nesh Cash for
0% payment money transfer. Oh, yeah, right.
You can get a Bitcoin wallet there. You can go to
PayPal.com/Brycas.
PayPal.
It's not even PayPal. It's PayPal. PayPal.com. It's PayPal. the Roman Church has opened up their fight for internet monetization.
You want to get that PayPal special mixtape release that he put out, you got to go to christianmingle.com/Brycas. Get those unreleased.
It used to be on Farmer's Meat.
Farmer's Meat.
And we moved.
Yeah. Yes. All right. I also like to thank our other guest, Domestic Dan, who's in his kitchen right now. Baked some cookies. Did a whole stream today via chat suggestion. Over on the front page of Twitch.
I gotta say,
today.
Dan has been in his kitchen for like I think 8 hours now. Have you not moved from that kitchen?
No, he's
7 hours.
7 hours in the kitchen. That's more Choco, please, again.
So that one, Choco may be able to be here.
Choco is a tired dog.
I think he might be sleeping.
Well, enjoy this for few moments now.
All right.
Yeah, so, 7 hours,
Yeah, so we're going to let Dan get out of here. Go check out Domestic Dan. Domestic Dan on Twitter. DomesticDan.com, DomesticDan.net, DomesticDan.org, Domestic
The best Dan. Damn Let's, cooker on the goddamn internet.
Domestic Dan. Hey. That's where you see Dan cook with people who were in the movie XXX.
I wish.
Dan gonna give it to you.
And for us, DrunkKidsGaming.com. If you're in the live chat, you know where to come. If you're not in the live chat, Lane Zero's here.
Zero's here.
.tv/DrunkKidsGaming and check out the show and the podcast over on iTunes. This is the longest outro I've ever done, so I'm just gonna stop.
I'm going to throw in the fact that yes, it is going to be up on iTunes in the next 24 hours. It will. I'm going to edit tonight. I do it every time now. I force myself to do it every time.
When Kaz asked me to be on, he said that the last time I was on,
those are on the Blu-ray. Those are going to be on extras on the Blu-ray. Okay.